And here's your host, Ryan Hukor! You know, your name was trending on Facebook the other day?
The football
player?
Probably the Pittsburgh Steelers. Yeah.
I saw Ryan Clark journey number two. I'm like, what did he do? Kill someone in the other room and I haven't heard about it yet? Anyways, what's going on? We're back this week. We were off last week.
We're back, man.
Well, I look particularly fat this week. Look at that, huh?
Let me tell you something, man.
Yeah.
For the next 2 hours, I'm not in a fucking very good mood right now, man.
No.
I'm really not.
I didn't know if
you were
going to bring it on the air with you or not, but yes.
It's not going anywhere, bro, and it's not going to go anywhere any fucking time soon, dude.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of things that have happened in the last couple of weeks. It's the reason why we weren't here.
Last week?
Last Tuesday night. Right. It was a very, very rough weekend around here.
Uh-huh.
And then, you know, an hour before the show, I get lied to my fucking face, man.
I told you to put it out of your brain until after the show.
How do you do that, man? Would you be able to do that, man?
Yeah, I would.
Yeah?
90% of what I do here is all phony bullshit. You see, the second the thing goes off, I'm a different person. Once that's on, hey, how we doing? Professional wrestling.
What's this?
make sure it doesn't restart in the middle of the show is what this is.
It's just unbelievable. That you do things for people, and you just...
You're not going to be able to allude to it without getting into it, so you shouldn't
fucked.
Even start.
You
I know.
Get fucked, man.
I know.
You get fucked over and
this
over.
This should be an off-the-air conversation.
Nice people
how
get
about,
fucked.
How about these nice fans didn't get a show
how about
last
the,
week?
They didn't get a nice... They didn't get a show
Let's
last
give them
week.
One this week.
Let's give them one this week, all right. Man. There's,
That shit on the side burner.
Let
it slow cook.
But there's...
Be burnt by 10 p.m.
Two big stories. Samoa Joe is gone from TNA Wrestling.
Yes.
That happened within the past week or so. And...
the Brock thing.
Brock Lesnar.
Yeah.
Today,
we don't really know all the details on that one.
Which is a bigger deal. He hasn't quit. You know, it's not a case of, you know, he's quit WWE, he's walked out like a CM Punk or a Steve Austin type deal.
You have to use the words walking out because he did literally walk out of the building last night in Nashville.
Right.
We'll get into
right.
the details in a second. Real quick, I do need to address at the top here why I'm wearing this ridiculous sweater.
It's fucking cold, man.
And why you're wearing a thing over your... I guess you wear that every week anyway.
Right.
But, yeah, I don't have anything like that to put over my shirt, so... This is the only thing with sleeves I got other than the shirt I stole from him. But it wasn't a sweater, so it's not heavy enough. It's freezing cold here in New York. This would be one rare time where actually if you gave the weather report...
Do you know
report,
that they take...
Or if
they,
you gave the weather report, it would make sense because we're wearing
they,
different clothes. So.
They do records all the way back
the
until like 1870 or 1880, something like that is where they keep records.
And this
too.
Is the coldest or what?
This is in the top three coldest Februarys. The average temperature through the entire month of February... has been like 12.7 degrees or 12.8 degrees.
That's well into the freezing.
Something like that. It has not been above 32 degrees here in Albany in 41 days. In 41 days straight, we have not hit 32 degrees. We haven't hit 32.
I've walked a mile in that weather two or three times in the last 40-some days.
We haven't hit 32. We haven't hit freezing. So, and the average temperature, I mean... When I got up this morning at about 9 o'clock, temperature was -8 out, man. And it's been going down to, like, negative... We're not talking, like, wind chills. We're talking, like, air temperatures of -15, -20 degrees below zero. And then you add the wind chills, and it's, like, -30, -35 below zero.
Yeah.
And it's been nonstop through the entire month of February, and there's no signs of it ending whatsoever. Yeah, the whole global
Parnelli
warming
says, and we're in global warming, ..
Yeah,
right.
You know, it's, and then we've got 2 to 3 feet of snow out there.
Yes, we do, and then about,
which,
I'd say a good 3 inches of ice everywhere you go.
Yeah, I mean, there's
big snow
there's,
banks of fucking 5 feet of snow next to every
there's
road.
Probably about 2.5 feet of snow, and it's been there for about a month.
It's
you're right.
Solid packed snow now.
And it just keeps piling up and up and up and up. And
you take a handful of that and hit somebody with a snowball, you might get arrested for murder.
It's been so
it's
cold.
So it's solid.
No, it's real powdery.
The snow banks.
Oh, the banks?
Yeah. It gets packed over
right.
and over and over again.
Right.
And the coldness keeps it freezing.
Yeah, it's... I mean, it's been... It's just been cold and
it's
snowy.
It's 72 where I am. It's 70
man.
Plus up here.
Yeah. I gotta be honest, dude. I love winter and I love snow and I love the cold.
Yes.
But when you go for 41 days, I believe 41 days straight of, you know, like 5 degrees, 10 degrees outside, it gets a little bit much.
As
where
much as we're bitching about
thinking,
the cold, getting kind of hot in here with this fucking heat on. Can I turn the heat off?
You want to?
Yeah,
it's
a little warm. I left it on for like 30 minutes so that it would be not freezing in here.
We can turn it off.
This room, by the way, everybody watching, gets way colder than any other room in the house.
Yes,
by far.
It does.
I think it's
the
two windows. I'm not sure, but something about this room is it's. I think I've dodged pneumonia about 20 times inside.
Yeah.
So
we had. We had WWE Fastlane on Sunday night, which I thought was a pretty good show, and then we had Monday Night Raw from last night, which I thought was a pretty good show.
I'll disagree. I thought Fastlane, while watching it, I'm like, oh, that's all. I thought Fastlane was great.
Okay.
They kept setting stage, like, you could see, oh, this is the beginning of their thing to WrestleMania.
I love this thing, Triple H.
Yeah, this is the beginning of their thing to WrestleMania. This is the beginning of their thing to WrestleMania. But then Raw last night was almost like a throwaway show, like, nothing really much happened.
No, they followed it up with WrestleMania.
Little
they
things,
announced...
but the things they followed up, I wasn't interested in. Like, we'll get into the specifics when we go through it, but I'm telling you right now, I sat there last night, I actually, for the first time in weeks, muted Raw, watched Breaking Bad on my computer, and would do play-by-play just off without sound. Like, I could do...
Really?
Anytime a promo came
wasn't
on...
wasn't bad last night.
Anytime a promo came on, I'd mute Breaking Bad, turn my volume up so that I could hear what's being said, but during a match where you don't need to hear anything, I would just sit there and I'd get enough to write, make it look nice and detailed, and then wait for the finish, write the finish up.
All right.
And that was Raw.
Right.
For matches. But,
we'll run it down top to bottom, but I think, you know, we're 5 weeks away from WrestleMania, which means we've got four more Raws.
They said last night,
March 29th.
30-some days. Yeah, all right, March 29th, I'll tell you right now.
March 29th, so I think
we've got
five Raws, maybe four.
Yeah, we've got the 2nd, the 9th, the 18th, the 23rd. So we got four more Raws.
And
then the 30th
and that's
is the post-Raw, yeah.
Four more Raws, and we've got the top three matches.
Into A-Train, it was Breaking Bad, but... because I got into Better Call Saul, I went back and rewatched the entire series of Breaking Bad.
Oh, jeez.
Because Better Call Saul is
a
prequel, which means it happened, whatever happens on the show, it means it happened before what we saw in Breaking Bad.
Right.
Not a sequel, a prequel.
Okay.
That's what Better Call Saul is. And it was, last
is that
night,
good, by the way?
Last night was episode 4, it was last night, but last week's show?
Yeah. It's good, huh?
It's going to be just as good as Breaking Bad.
Really?
Can already tell. Like,
same writer?
Same creator, same owner. I don't know if it's the same staff writing the episodes, but I believe it is. And it's the same people for the most part. Like, a couple of them that you saw in Breaking Bad that were key players, and then, you know, staff around them. But it's a fucking amazing show.
Yeah.
And after first two episodes were awesome.
Right.
Episode 3 was, like, jaw-dropping awesome. So when I saw that, I was like, oh, fuck, man, I got to go rewatch Breaking Bad just so anything I forget about this character, I'll remember when I watch his show. And last night was episode 4. I downloaded it, watched it today. And it was good, but every once in a while, it's hard to explain if you don't watch a show, but every once in a while there's an episode that they have to do to, like, kind of give you information so that what you see next actually matters. You know what I mean? Kind of like on Raw, where you get the big 25-minute boring opening segment so that the matches later on make sense. You know why people are fighting because of this opening argument they had.
Right.
So last night's Better Call Saul was like an episode to set up future episodes. So it was kind of
But
even then, it was still good. Bottom line, it's an amazing fucking show. I've got a new fucking show.
So we've got the top three matches. Not the top three matches, but we've got three matches confirmed for WrestleMania 31 right now. Get the little one out of the way. We've got the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. They confirmed that on Raw last night. We've got The Miz, Curtis Axel,
Ryback.
And Ryback as the three names. I'm sure they're going to announce more names on SmackDown. But
obviously.
I guess, you know, we put it up on the websites. We actually put it up last year. I remember putting it up. This is going to be an annual thing at WrestleMania. And you know what?
Well, we knew that, but then there was starting to be questions coming into this Mania whether they were going to do it or not. And then last night they decided.
It's a way to get everybody on the show. I mean, if you're a WWE superstar, if your goal is to be able to, number one, main event WrestleMania. Obviously, only two guys, or unless they do a three-way or a four-way,
which is
something like that. You're not going to main event WrestleMania. There's only going to be two, three, maybe four guys that are going to main event WrestleMania. But if you can't main event WrestleMania, you want to be on WrestleMania. And it's a way to take 30 guys that don't have matches at WrestleMania and get them on the card. Right. So they're going to do it
again. The Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal.
They used to do a pre-show type.
Pre-show Battle Royal where Raw guys would wear red shirts, SmackDown guys would wear blue shirts, and it was just a fucking clusterfuck just to get people a paycheck.
To get everybody on the show.
Get people a paycheck.
To have that experience.
To get the people a paycheck because Mania checks are bigger than any other checks of the year.
Right.
And because, it's like a prestige thing. I was part of WrestleMania.
Right, exactly. Just get everybody on the show. To be out there in front of 70, 80,000 people that's awesome.
Yeah, because it's the one time of year where WWE pays wrestlers that to have their families come in,
right.
Like if you want to. So if you have your family in and you're not even on the show,
right?
Like Total Divas that one year, that one of the first episodes of the history of that reality show.
Yeah, they bumped the match.
Was
right.
How they got bumped and documenting all that backstage.
Right. And then we've got the main event, which looks like it's a go.
I mean, it was officially announced. They could still change it.
And they could add. I mean,
last year they had Orton Batista, and then they changed it.
Changed it and added that third guy.
But as things stand right now, Roman Reigns, Brock Lesnar, World Heavyweight Championship. That's the main event.
And that's what Vince wants. And I saw what they did on Raw last night.
It was the same thing they did in the Royal Rumble.
Well,
they had somebody that the fans love
that
endured.
Try to put over Roman Reigns. That's exactly what it was.
They had
the
Rock try at Rumble.
Where Vince, and I'm thinking Vince is backstage saying, listen, Roman Reigns is my guy. I am going to make this son of a bitch work.
Let's get
no matter how
mark.
I got
to
do
Let's
it.
Let's get the internet mark to get the internet rub over here to Roman Reigns.
I am going
to
take Roman Reigns
is my
guy.
Get the fan mark with the Rock. Get the rub over here to Roman Reigns.
That is exactly what Raw was last night.
Let's have a thief sister get the rub. Oh, whoops. Wrong thing. I'm sorry.
That is exactly what I'm thinking backstage. Vince has got, and you can see this, and you could see it after Raw last night.
I'm gonna hear about that one.
Vince has got his mind dead set on Roman Reigns.
Yes.
It's his guy, it's his pet project, and he's gonna make Roman Reigns work. And he's gonna force feed it down the fans' throats over and over and over again.
What do you think about that decision?
And if the fans are booing him right now, listen, somebody came out the other day, was it Ric Flair or Shawn Michaels, said the fans need to give Roman Reigns a chance. And while I agree that in the future, Roman Reigns is going to be a big fucking deal.
I'm not so sure about that anymore.
I just don't think he's got the look.
He'll definitely be a player.
He's got the look, though. He's got the look that Vince wants.
Yeah, I know.
I just don't think he's not there yet.
For the longest time,
not there yet.
It was inevitable. This guy's going to be the guy, just a matter of when.
Yeah.
I think what they did was they pulled the trigger too soon.
Too soon.
And
right.
Now it's a question, will this guy ever be the guy? He'll always be a player. He'll always be high mid-card, maybe even a main eventer, but not the guy of the company.
Right.
I think they might have botched the attempt of making him the guy. They did it too soon. If you look back,
and they did the corny jokes with it too, and I think
too,
that ruined them a little
but
bit.
But if you look, like they just had this DVD come out I watched the other day called The Destruction of the Shield.
Mm-hmm.
Their latest documentary.
Did you watch it again?
Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah. I watched the preview on the network and then I downloaded it illegally the next day and watched the whole thing. It was alright, pretty good. Yeah. A lot of it was from the Journey to SummerSlam documentary they did on the Shield when they first broke up.
Right.
But it pretty much, if you watch that, you know Roman Reigns didn't even, they did the same thing with him in developmental.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he was immediately looked at in developmental like, this guy's a big deal,
mm-hmm.
right when he first started.
Mm-hmm.
And they kind of fast-tracked him
mm-hmm.
all the way to fast lane. And, you know what I mean? They didn't take their time and groom him and get him ready the way they did
with
Cena, Lesnar,
right.
Orton, Batista,
right.
and OVW back
right.
when they had that developmental system.
Yep.
They rushed Reigns right through it.
Straight through,
whereas
right.
guys like Rollins had time to stay there and season. Ambrose, Moxley had time to season, you know.
Right, right.
Reigns,
right.
they fast-tracked him straight from developmental to main roster, and then when he got to the main roster, they fast-tracked him from part of a group to he's our future. And he wasn't ready.
That's Vince's guy.
And what sucks was, if you look back during the Shield, everybody loved Roman Reigns.
Yeah.
Even
the
diehard Mark internet fans loved
right,
him because he was one of...
He was the guy.
Yeah, he wasn't being... We weren't being fucking, this is the guy, you son of a bitch, this is the guy! Like, we were allowed to like him organically. The second they started doing that shit to us,
right.
it's like, well, I like him better. Daniel
they
Bryan,
are shoving,
you know.
And this is Vince. You know it's Vince because Roman is Vince's guy.
He's got the look,
and,
the size.
And, you know, I think Vince started... seeing the booze, and that he wasn't the booze.
Oh,
from,
I was
from
booze.
From the crowd.
yeah.
You know, fans were starting to boo him, And last night, they took a guy, like you said earlier, a guy in Daniel Bryan that the fans love, and they had Daniel come out and fully endorse him, shook his hand, and said, "You are the next big thing. Do me a favor and go out there and kick Brock Lesnar's ass at WrestleMania."
Yeah.
This, that, and the other thing. So they are trying. And by the end of that segment, granted...
Well, he even gave him the, "You're a good wrestler."
You're a good wrestler.
Like, he was, like, trying to let the fans know. Like, I'm telling you guys...
This is
he's not
this
just
guy.
Hype, he's really
right.
good. I didn't
right.
know it until I shared the ring with him last night at Fastlane.
Right.
But after being in the ring with
they
him,
had
I'm
Daniel
telling
Bryan
you, he's a good wrestler.
Fully endorsed
yeah.
him. I mean, fully
They tried
endorsed.
To convert whatever love Daniel Bryan has
had
fans,
over to Roman Reigns.
And had Daniel Bryan
absolutely.
Pretty much in an indirect way say, "Guys, over here with that love,
absolutely.
Please." You know? And it's not going to work.
It's not
going to doesn't transfer that easily. You either like the guy or you don't. And
look,
a lot of people don't like
Roman Reigns. Here's the deal. What happens at WrestleMania 31? Let's be honest. Everybody hates Brock Lesnar. I mean, they boo the shit out of Brock.
They don't.
Now at WrestleMania, during the main event, let me ask you.
They
just
cheer Brock Lesnar. What are you talking about?
I mean, we've got four. They cheer
they
Paul Heyman.
Father,
they cheer Paul Heyman, not
opposite.
Brock.
Opposite. They boo Paul Heyman.
No, they love Paul.
If they turn Brock on Paul tonight,
okay.
Brock would be the biggest baby face in the
biggest game. Baby face.
Because the fans want to like him. The only reason they don't is because Heyman.
Really?
The fans love a badass son of a bitch. That's why Stone Cold was the biggest baby face ever. They love Brock because he's the only organic killer on the roster right now.
I think it's Paul.
If they gave the fan, I think it's the opposite. I think the only reason they boo Lesnar is because Heyman does the 21-1.
When Paul's cutting those promos, right?
That's why they boo.
And the crowd's like, yeah!
They don't
They're
boo.
Cheap.
Yeah, they boo.
Fuck yeah, they do. When Paul Heyman's out there cutting promos, the crowd...
He does the Undertaker streak thing that's cheap. Because
Paul Heyman's promos are so fucking good.
They are.
The crowd says,
no,
yo, Paul is the
man. You're looking
at
a small percentage of the fan
But if Brock gets on that microphone...
You're looking at a small percentage of the fan base. The diehard fans love anything Heyman does, and that's what we are. Yeah, if we were there, Paul!
Okay.
Casual fans, young kids, casual fans, older people.
All right.
They do not cheer Paul Heyman because he's good. They don't cheer him at all. They boo him. And if you go watch his promos, there are people booing, lots of them.
Right.
Those are the audience that's booing him. The reason they boo him is because he goes and he cuts promos. And even though they're so good, they're designed to make you boo. He tells you, "Hey, we killed the Undertaker streak that you love so much." Boo! If they weren't doing that, Lesnar would be a mega babyface right now.
If you gave Paul a microphone or Brock a microphone, and you have both guys speak, the crowd's going to cheer Heyman, and they're going to boo Brock. Brock sucks on the microphone. Brock's terrible on
You're
the microphone.
You're looking at people's like talent or ability, not their character.
I mean, every week we see Paul Heyman come out and cut promos, and the crowd boos him. The crowd boos him, but
and
all of
a sudden, Z-Train just cut it down for you. There you
Smarks
go.
Smarks cheer Heyman. I agree with that.
You didn't
the
finish
smart
the
marks. The marks boo him.
There you go.
Well, the smart marks.
Marks are us. Smart marks.
Right, absolutely.
Marks
cheer Heyman.
Fans.
Right. But those
boo
same
him.
Those same people.
The same people that boo Heyman chant, "You sold out at Seth Rollins," even though he didn't
absolutely.
Sell anything.
Absolutely.
He
right
over the group because of a storyline. Like back in the day, "You sold out" meant something. It was a guy leaving a company because somebody offered him more money. So you sold out and you're taking the money to go over here.
Right.
Rollins didn't do anything, but like. Do his storyline one
that
week, and it
I
became
know.
Popular as chant, "You sold out."
Hey, you know what I did like to switch to a different angle? The Randy Orton, Seth Rollins stuff. Speaking of Seth Rollins, on Raw last night, you didn't like that?
I didn't.
You know what? It was too obvious to me what was going to happen, where, all right, early in the night,
nothing
they set
happened.
It up. Yeah, but early in the night,
it was a cliffhanger at the end.
But listen, early in the night, they set it up, all right, Randy Orton, we can forget all past issues aside, let's forget, and, you know, I'm back in the authority. Then at the end of the night, you knew when they set up that tag team match, you knew that Randy Orton and Seth were going to have some
Did you watch Raw last night?
I did.
Because it's pretty you much, knew, again, it's the opposite of what you're saying. They started the show explaining why Orton hates the authority, why he doesn't trust. They showed this curb stomp on the table.
Right, and then we go backstage.
All right, so he's saying he doesn't want nothing to do with him, blah, 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 blah. And then finally,
right.
they talk about a business meeting, and Orton's like, "Oh, you know
they
what? I'll be part of this business meeting."
And they shake hands.
At the end of the show, how did Raw end last night? Do you remember?
Yeah,
how
I do.
It, end?
It ended with Rollins and Orton tease some heat between the two.
Orton picked Rollins up, helped him up. Did like that.
Tapped him on the back. But what happened right before that?
He was going to kick him in the face.
He was going to kick him in the face.
Yeah.
But he didn't. So they're teasing. I'm trying to say.
Yeah. No, I know
they're teasing that Rollins and Orton over the next 4 weeks going into WrestleMania.
And that's why I don't like it.
Are going to have some issues.
That's why I don't like it.
Why? It's going to
lead to... He should have came right out and had his issues last night with them, and then the next 4 weeks should be how deep do these issues go,
yeah, but
how do they handle them.
If they did that last night, you've got 4 weeks.
Yeah.
4 weeks. So it's a slow build where
that's
they come out and they start to tease the tension last night. They teased the tension last night. Now next week, they tease tension again. The week after that, Randy Orton.
If you're
going to
do it that way,
Randy Orton.
If you're
going to
do
the
slow build,
you've got 2 weeks.
If you're going to do the slow build tension tease, you shouldn't have brought up why Orton's been gone. You shouldn't have brought up what Rollins did to him. He should have came back as part of the authority, helped Rollins, and then maybe every once in a while throw a little tease in there. And if fans are wondering why, and then on week three or two leading into Mania, he does the promo. Oh, maybe you guys forget what happened.
They could have done it that way.
You know what I mean? That's a slow build. But if you're going to immediately come out and say, this is why I'm gone, I hate your fucking guts, I'll never work with you again, I'll never trust you, and then 2 seconds later, oh, I'll trust you, and then a little tease of a kick, and then, never mind.
I don't know.
Good. And
Hear me out here, man.
Listen, I'm just telling you my thing.
Last night, Randy Orton comes out, and for one night on Raw, they swerved the fans.
They
swerved them a little bit. Everybody thought,
through that.
A lot of people thought in the opening segment.
What is he up to? We know he's fucking around when he says, oh, all right, I'll be part of this
game.
Let me
talk here.
Please do.
All right. Randy Orton comes out last night, man, and they go backstage to the conference call. All right. They get to the
business meeting
backstage, right? Randy Orton winds up joining the authority. What most people thought is when Randy Orton comes back, he's going right after Seth Rollins. He's taking him out, and they're going
to
set up a Seth Rollins versus
Fastlane?
Randy Orton.
He returned at Fastlane. What did he do?
He returned at Fastlane and RKO'd Rollins.
Okay.
RKO'd Rollins. And that's why Orton came out to open Raw.
So that's why I don't like that they started
Orton.
Going that direction.
But wait a minute. Orton comes out to open Raw last night, and he's like, I want Seth Rollins out of here right now.
Yes.
I'm pissed off at what he did. That's where Stephanie came out and said, calm the fuck down. Listen, you come back home, right? Come to the authority.
Yeah. We're stronger together than you.
So everybody thought, I mean, at least I did, I thought this segment, this opening segment, is going to end with Randy Orton RKOing Seth Rollins. Instead, they said, no, let's do a business meeting backstage. Later in the night, they did the business meeting. They shook hands.
Yeah.
So you're thinking, wow, you know what? Randy Orton's back in the authority.
Here's what I got to jump in. And it's pause. Keep your thoughts right
it's
there.
Slow
real
build.
Quick, the
I
shake
like
hand
it.
Thing, you're not supposed to think, oh, Randy Orton's back. You're obviously supposed to think that's why they did it this way.
Tension between
what's
the two.
He doing? Obviously, he's pretending to be back, but he's not. So why is he pretending? That's the slow build. So we still haven't got
the
answer.
You don't like that?
Right?
You don't like
I don't,
that.
I don't. I think
I
it would
like
have been
that.
Better to just do a straight up, I don't like you.
Straight up, I'm back, RKO,
yeah.
Me and you, let's do it.
And
we're
then
doing it at WrestleMania.
The last 4 weeks is Orton trying to overcome
weeks.
The numbers game. And they've
if
got
come,
Big Show and Kane and
but
Rollins
wait a minute.
And J&J
but wait a minute.
And Triple H.
If you come back and Randy Orton goes straight after Seth Rollins,
yeah.
You got 5 weeks, including last night, okay? You got 5 weeks that you got to do Randy Orton, Seth Rollins, right?
Yeah.
That's going to get old. In 4 or 5 weeks, what are you going to do? Promo week after week.
Get old.
I hate you. No, I hate you. You hate me. I hate you.
Bro,
we're face off at WrestleMania.
Not going to get old. Cena Rusev has been going on for 3 or 4 weeks already. We got 4 more of that to go still.
That I don't agree with.
Wyatt Taker, we've had going for 4 weeks. We got 4 more. Sting Triple H, we've had going for like 3 months.
But we haven't seen Sting and Triple H. Grant, I loved what Triple H did.
We haven't seen Orton until last night.
I loved what Triple H did last night.
Yeah.
What's the thing?
I got a whole
work?
Column I got to write about this Sting thing. Because basically, unless I'm confusing something, he's the heel. Sting is the heel.
No, Triple H
is
the authority.
It's WCW versus WWE is the way they're building it. Sting
yeah,
is the face of WCW.
Triple H.
I'm the face of WWE.
Come on, man.
Ric Flair, short of my kids and my wife, I'll do anything to save the WWE. Sting is the WCW guy.
Dude.
Blah, 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 blah. Unless I'm missing something here, how the fuck are we supposed to hate Triple H? Answer me this.
How are we supposed
answer
to hate
question.
Triple H? I watch Raw every week.
Listen,
I see the authority.
That's the storyline. I'm talking. The way they're building this match is, I'm the guy as the face of WWE. You're the guy that's the face of WCW. Why are we supposed to root for WCW to beat WWE? Answer me this question. Why do we hate Triple H in this program?
We hate Triple
when
H
he
because
says,
he's part of the
when
authority.
Oh,
no,
you're looking at something
we
different.
Said, but Triple H's current gimmick right now, his current character is a top heel in the company.
And
he's a heel. He's a heel.
Correct.
He's one of the biggest heels on Raw. I understand him and Stephanie McMahon.
Bro.
Biggest heels.
Formulaic speaking, I understand.
I get it.
He is technically wearing
but
his heels.
Sting's an outsider. He's coming in from WCW.
And he's they all the WCW guy.
They are
why are we supposed
up.
To root for this WCW guy? Answer this question. When Triple H...
WCW
when Triple H
10 years ago. You know, it was
when
so
Triple
ago.
H tells Flair, I'll do anything... Short of my kids and my wife, this company means more to me than anything. WWE, I'll do anything to stop anybody that tries to hurt this company.
Right.
Why are we supposed to boot Triple H for that reason?
It's, listen,
that's
it's,
the story of this match. Forget, well, oh, he's part of the authority. Which, by the way, during all this Orton stuff that happened last night, Triple H didn't say one word the entire show.
That's what I just said.
He stood there mute and not even dealing with it because he's thinking about Triple H. So he's trying to defend WWE,
Sting.
He's trying to defend the WWE against the face of WCW who's finally showing up to fucking claim war. Why are we supposed to root for Sting to beat Triple H when Triple H is WWE? Sting is WCW. Why?
If WCW was still active today and going, and you would have a guy from WCW on outside, I get it. They're trying to build up WCW versus WWE. Triple H is the face of WWE. This is what we're watching. It's WWE at WrestleMania. It's not WCW WrestleMania. Why would they do this? Yes. If WCW was still an active company this day and you've got an outsider coming in to face the WWE guy at a WWE pay-per-view, Triple H is going to be that baby face because Triple H is, represents WWE. Sting represents WCW. Problem is,
why
WCW,
did they even bring into the mix?
I don't know.
Sting should have been the vigilante that's here to fucking set the authority straight. Company wore out of
Sting's, it. Sting's never been in WWE. Everybody knows him from WCW back in the day. But WCW is no longer an active company, obviously. This was 10 years ago. You bring Sting in from WCW. Now he's the WWE guy, obviously. There is no WCW anymore.
There's still
the
a TNA.
I don't
that's
think
where
the WCW
from,
versus
7 years.
I don't think WCW versus WWE. I mean, yes, I get that they're building it up that way, but I don't think it's
that's my
that
beef.
I don't think it's that big of a deal.
No,
everybody knows Triple H is
not
a major heel.
And
in
I'm
WWE.
Nitpicking. But what I'm
you
saying
are
is
nitpicking.
I'm nitpicking, but at the same time, if you're a fan that you're talking like a fan like me and you that knows everything that's been around watching for 20 years.
Right.
There's a casual audience that doesn't know shit except for what WWE tells them.
But
they're going
they
out of their way to remind
yes,
everybody, this
yes.
guy used to be our biggest enemy. He was the Hulk Hogan of the other company.
Right.
And now he's here, and Triple H is saying, yo, I fucking married the boss's daughter. I love this company more than anything to my family.
Right.
If some fucking former WCW's version of Hulk Hogan wants to come in here,
I get that.
I'll stop it at any cost.
That.
You should cheer a guy like that. No, wouldn't you? Like, yeah, get him then, man.
I get that.
If it was real life.
I know.
It's a storyline, and because, all right, he's wearing a black hat, Triple H, and Sting's wearing a white hat, we cheer him, we boo him, because that's our job. No, you're supposed to watch the story, and based on the story, say, this guy's a piece of shit, or this guy's a nice guy, whatever. And now that seems a piece of shit. But when they did the invasion, for example, the invasion angle, when they bought WCW, do you remember what was going on then? Stone Cold Steve Austin was in the middle of trying to be a heel. And it wasn't working. And their Austin heel turn wasn't working. And so what'd they do? Let's make him part of WCW. Everybody hates the fans. Anything WCW related, the fans would shit all over. So they said, all right, we're trying to get Austin over as a heel. Throw a WCW shirt on him. He's a heel.
Mm.
So now in Sting's gimmick when he comes in is, you're the main WCW guy of all time. And I'm one of the main WWE guys of all time. And even on the promo, Triple H says that. Yeah, you were trying to put this company out of business, he says to Sting. Why would you cheer Sting? He tried to put us out of business. And I'm one of the guys that puts you out of business. Good job, Triple H, WWE win. Why are we booing him for saying that? Why are we cheering Sting?
We're booing Triple H because the way that... I mean, listen, we know that Triple H is a top heel already. The way that he delivers these promos and shits all over Sting, that's the reason we're booing Triple H. We know Triple H is a major heel right now. We know that... I mean, you're really nitpicking here, but when Sting comes in, it's his first time being in WWE. The match is going to be held under a WWE roof at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Fans, whenever Sting comes out, I mean, Jesus, at Fast Lane. See the pop Sting got? It was
not that great.
It was pretty fucking good, man. Well, the whole crowd at Fastlane and Raw last night wasn't that good.
I was going to say, I didn't think that pop was that great, to be honest with you.
You know,
if they would have built the pop differently, it probably would have been, but
I thought the segment was good. And now, let me ask you this. Do we see Sting cut any promo before WrestleMania?
I hope so, because...
Or do we see Sting come in and not say a word and
points
just
bat
come in.
And shit.
He just points to the WrestleMania sign.
The most successful thing he did in WCW was that program with Hogan and the NWO at Starrcade. And that was built up for over a full year, and Sting never said one word.
Never said a word.
And it worked perfectly.
Never said a word. Right.
What WWE
needs
to realize is this isn't 1999 anymore.
Right.
Or yeah, whatever, 98, whatever it was. 98, 99. It's fucking 16
By
years
the way,
later, you know.
You want to, here, you want to have a little fun with me?
Go ahead.
So Ryback comes out last night, and he cuts a promo, right? And it was a pretty fucking badass promo, right? I'm telling you, man.
I didn't catch it.
Yeah, oh, that's right, you had it muted.
Yeah,
sometimes.
I didn't hear that.
It was a pretty fucking badass promo, and I said to the people, I say, that raspy voice, that badass attitude that he had right now, doesn't remind you, and everybody said, no, it's Goldberg, it reminds you, and I said to the people, I said, yeah, the look-wise, absolutely.
So voice-wise, he's Austin, look-wise, he's Goldberg?
Absolutely.
All right, so
absolutely.
When you add all that up, who is he?
Ah, well, with the voice, all right, with the look, with
voice
the look,
and a look is not that big of a piece of the pie of what makes a guy good or not.
With the
good.
Look, with the look, he's Goldberg, without a doubt. With
okay.
The look, he's Goldberg.
And RVD. Singlet with all the colors and the shit.
Yeah, he's got the singlet and everything else.
Yeah.
But with the look, absolutely, he's Goldberg, right?
Okay.
But I saw something on the microphone last night, and he briefly cut a promo. He was out there with Curtis Axel, with the whole Axel.
By the way,
Curtis Axel last night showed some personality during that promo too, man. He had the facial expressions. He had the promo. It wasn't a great promo by any means. Don't think that I'm. I still think Curtis Axel falls flat as a motherfucker. Always has problems. But last night, I thought there was some personality that came out of Curtis Axel.
Don't,
a little bit.
Don't bring up the fact that he was wearing a Hulk Hogan T-shirt with red and yellow. You know why? Because I'll get upset. You want to know why I'll get upset?
You know what? I kind of wondered that, but Axelmania, he had instead
of...
Well,
I'm not talking about wrestling, I'm talking about personal shit, and why I'd get upset.
All right.
I spent about 5 weeks growing a big, giant beard and a big fucking goatee.
Okay.
Why? Because I was going to shave this part... Shave this part and have the big fucking Hulk Hogan thing going for a show, and then you canceled the show last week, so I couldn't use my big Hulk Hogan thing anymore.
Why couldn't you have?
I couldn't keep it any longer
because
it was bothering me every night. I kept waiting. Oh, Tuesday's only a couple days away. Blah blah blah. Blah. And then you canceled. I said I can't take another week of this shit, and I shaved it all off.
I
was gonna come in. I was gonna have no. This was after that. It was Tuesday, last Tuesday.
Okay.
We were fine starting all Sunday right. night, Monday morning. But anyways, so I had already had it planned out in my head. I said, I'm going to make Ryan wait. I'm going to introduce the show one week. I'm going to come in here and I'm going to do a big, cheesy, corny, well, let me tell you something, brother. And I was going to do the whole fucking gimmick and everything. Let me
Thank
tell you something,
God.
Those are maniac brothers. You know.
Thank God we canceled that.
It
would have
been fun.
Jesus.
It would have been fun.
Thank
I
God
threw
we
all
canceled.
That for nothing, man.
Thank God we canceled.
Anyways,
man. Yeah. Anyways, let's get these plugs out of the way. We'll get into it. We've already talked a little bit about Fastlane and Raw from last night, but we'll run it down.
Well, let me tell you something, WCR brothers.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
Yeah.
Not bad. Not bad. The official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZROnline.com. We are on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/WZRArmy, YouTube.com/WZRArchive. Daniel does a great job over there.
He was asking about us the other day.
We're on Twitter as well. Just go to WZROnline.com, top navigation bar. It's got a drop-down menu. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, WZROnline.com. Got all the latest news, Whoa. Rumors, backstage stories, the latest on Brock Lesnar and WWE, what happened last night at Raw, which we're going to talk about here in just a little bit, Samoa Joe leaving TNA, and we also, you know, Paige has been coming out in some recent interviews.
I'm starting to think that's a bit of a worked shoot.
Basically saying that
I think there's a little seedling of reality to it, but I think they're making it more than what it is with the way they're going back and forth.
I don't think Charlotte
I'm about
is.
Charlotte.
Yeah, I don't think Charlotte's ready to be called up.
I don't think either.
I think Sasha Banks.
I said that the other week on the show.
I think she's ready.
Yeah, I said more than Charlotte. I think Sasha would be the one.
The problem
she's
is
got the character and the work in the ring.
The problem is they took the NXT Divas title off Charlotte at the recent NXT special, which would lead
instead
you
instead of red and yellow, I'll wear a gray and black old man sweater. Says Carmella. Yeah. That's because of what I'm wearing.
The fact that they took the title off
like an old man sweater.
I don't like
it's
it.
A nice sweater, right?
I like it.
Yeah.
The fact that they took the NXT Divas title off Charlotte a couple of weeks ago or last week.
Was that the NXT before? Takeover?
Yeah.
Our Revolution or whatever the fuck it was called.
Our Revolution. It was
Our Evolution.
No, it was
NXT Takeover, NXT, Our Evolution. No.
That was the previous one, wasn't it?
I thought this that was one was, the previous one.
This one was NXT Arrival.
Rival.
Rival.
NXT Takeover
Rivals. Rivals. Or
yeah,
Rival.
Like that, yeah.
Right. But the fact that they got the title off Charlotte would lead Rival. You to believe that she is going to be called up sooner than later. Now, they did the NXT TV tapings, so
although
she is going to be there through WrestleMania.
They
so.
Took the title off Zayn, too. You think Zayn's coming up?
That's true, yeah.
I think they just did that to keep the Owens and Zayn thing interesting.
They did put Alex Riley, who I, over the years, have said time and time again that I see a lot of potential in that guy.
You got a good track record when it comes to calling who's going to become something way before it happens.
You know, and I say it about Ryback too, but I think Ryback's ego gets in the way where and the attitude and the ego where the second this guy starts getting a push, I mean, I remember he was in the main event with John Cena. They were on top of the ambulance.
Yeah, and there was Hell in a Cell that he was with Punk.
So he was in the main event, and then they said that the attitude and the ego got the best of him, and they said, whoa.
Well, that, and if you believe Punk, what he said, which, by the way, that's the other story we can talk about.
He's a stiff worker, right? Yeah, the lawsuit.
Yeah, that's how long we've been gone. But anyways, yeah, if you believe Punk, and this is the thing that kept RVD from ever getting to the top, funny enough, RVD Ryback has the same. But he's considered, like, careless, and like, he hurts people.
Yeah.
And RVD would never get ahead, because he would hurt. Remember when he had the Elimination Chamber, and he crushed Triple H's fucking...
Esophagus,
whatever that's called. What's that called?
RVD's always been known as a pretty dangerous worker, though.
And not careless.
Yeah. Let me say something about CM Punk. I'm not so sure that the things that CM Punk said in that podcast... I mean, I'm sure there was a lot of truth in there. I'm not saying there wasn't.
I think he's exaggerating.
I think he may have fucked himself here. Shot himself in the ass
here,
man.
Well, he definitely fucked himself, but do you think he's telling the truth or not?
That's two different things. I mean, WWE released that video, and granted, during the podcast...
I'm gonna say this way, I think he was 100% honest as far as what he thinks.
Yes.
But he still fucked himself. So fucking yourself and being honest, two different things.
WWE released the video, and clearly there was no bump on his back. But
there was. In
Punk's defense...
It's nearly as bad as he made it sound.
In Punk's defense, he also said that it was below the waist.
He said it was right at the waistband.
So, right at the waistband. Yeah. So, and WWE releases a video, and it didn't look like a big deal when they released the video, but could it have been underneath the trunks? Did we not see it on the video? But I think that, you know, WWE, and clearly WWE is backing Chris Hammond, the doctor.
Well, here's the question. Why did they wait? I mean, that podcast was in November, right? Or December? November? Why did they wait until now to just do all of that?
Well, I mean, granted, when you file a lawsuit, you've got to talk to lawyers.
I'll
you've got to
you
find
right
a
now.
Lawyer that's going to represent you.
You just said it and you don't even know.
You've
got to
find a...
Here's what they did. If they've got a vendetta against this CM Punk, which I think they do, I think
they do.
They really don't like him. They want to fuck with him.
They want to fuck
him. I would even say Triple H specifically would say, here's a recording. It goes to some really good lawyers.
This isn't WWE's lawsuit. This is WWE's doctor filing the lawsuit, but WWE's backing him
up.
That's
my point.
Right.
Triple H probably took the podcast, went to the team of lawyers, and I used to know the fucking name, Jerry McDivitt, and all those guys, and he said, listen to this podcast. Comb through it. Anything that we can sue this piece of shit for.
Oh, they're going to do it.
Let us know.
Absolutely.
And then they probably told him, and the Amon thing came up. They probably conferred with Amon, talked to him. What's on record? What's on file? What's official? And what's...
Well, they talk to Amon and say that, listen...
So that's probably why it took this long to come out.
If you're
because they wanted to make sure they had a legal case before they went with it.
If you're Dr. Amon and WWE's lawyer, Jerry McDivitt comes up to you and says, hey man, what CM Punk said to you in the podcast, is that true? And Amon says, no, absolutely.
Yeah,
it's
let me
not
see
true,
paperwork.
Right?
What
Jerry McDivitt says, listen, you can become a millionaire and you ain't got to do anything. We will represent you. We will go to court.
I think it's
to
more
bat for you. I mean, WWE.
It's not to make him a millionaire. It's more of they want to
fuck him. Punk. They want to fuck him.
Yeah,
absolutely.
So like, obviously, they don't need money, but if we could, any dollar we can take out of Punk's wallet right
absolutely.
Now,
absolutely,
I'll take it.
I'll
just
take it.
Fuck him over.
That's what they're doing.
Same way, you
That's
think it's a coincidence they gave him his fucking you're fired paperwork on his wedding day?
No,
they clearly have a thing
not.
With this guy where they want to say nanny nanny boo boo, you stupid bastard. You know, what I mean? They want to fuck with him.
Listen,
and this
he walked.
Ways.
He walked out on them. At a time where they really needed him, man.
This time last year,
WrestleMania.
Right after the Rumble. After the Rumble, he walked out.
Punk wanted to main event WrestleMania. It was a bad time for CM Punk to walk away from WWE. And basically, CM Punk gave him, fuck you, I'm out. And this is WWE's way of saying,
well, and then going on the podcast,
back, man.
Going on the podcast is where he really made himself an enemy.
Right.
Like,
right.
He made himself public enemy number one to the top brass.
Do you think he, what do you think about this lawsuit? Does Punk have a shot? Or do they settle out of court? I don't think they settle. I don't think WWE wants a settlement.
I think
WWE is taking this
to court.
They want
to make his life miserable.
There ain't no settlement. Yeah. We are going to make your life miserable. During your UFC training, granted, you've got a fight coming up this year.
That's
and it's probably about the same time where he's going to be in court. What? 5, 6, 7 months from now, where
I was telling my
he's
going to
be
night,
dealing
said,
with a lawsuit.
I swear to God, if this bullshit fucks up his UFC debut for us, and we can't cash in on this big fucking fight he's going
to
do.
You know, and it's a perfect time for WWE to file a lawsuit, because you know that it's not going to wind up in court for 5, 6, 7, 8 months from now, right around the time where CM Punk's getting ready.
Well, even if it doesn't
fight,
no matter what happens,
it's
enough that
it's pretty good timing.
It's enough that he can't just, he thought he was done.
Yeah.
Everything with WWE and everything with pro wrestling is behind me. It's done.
Yeah.
Now I focus on this.
Yeah.
Now he can't singularly focus on this because he's got all these lawyers saying, "Hey, you need to come talk to us today," and this and that. But I got a train, bro. You need to come talk to us. We got some serious shit here. Bro. They fucked him.
They got him too. And don't forget about Colt Cabana is also involved in this lawsuit. Although, granted, Colt didn't necessarily come out. I would have to go back and rewind the podcast.
Well,
but it was
according to the lawsuit, he. They're fucking with Cabana just as hard.
Yeah.
They're saying Cabana and Punk, basically, in the long story
short.
But Colt
just kind of played along and agreed.
No, not so much. I mean, it was to the point where he said enough that they are accusing him of publicly disparaging a licensed doctor and making him seem incompetent and this and that. So that's enough to, what do they call it, slander.
Defamation of character.
Defamation of character, slander, all that shit. Yeah, they can get them for that, too. So
that's the thing. Everybody, a lot of people in the comments section, you know, saying freedom of speech, what happened to that? You can't, I mean, if you are coming out and you're saying things that
you're making medical,
you are making accusations,
medical
that
accusations.
That are, that what Amon believes are completely false, you can't, and that makes him look bad.
He's got the WWE roster. Let's just say 400 people, right? Wrestlers, not employees. My God, they got thousands of employees. Wrestlers.
No, there's not 400 wrestlers.
I'm just saying a number.
We'll say 80 to 100, but okay.
80 to 100 wrestlers. Just way more than that. It's got to be more than that.
I don't
anyways,
think so.
It's got to be more.
Raw, SmackDown, and
NXT.
Probably 45. Oh, NXT, too.
You throw it all. Like, everybody that's under contract with WWE, this is the doctor that oversees their health.
Absolutely.
If they paint that guy as an incompetent doctor, that's a serious thing because all these people rely on him to make sure they're safe.
Mm-hmm.
So if Punk says, "Yeah, I had a concussion at the Rumble," and he's like, "What do you want me to do?"
Well, how would you feel if you were Dr. Amon and you've got somebody saying this about you and you know that it's not the truth?
I would
see flat out lying.
I would
be pissed off, right?
What's his name? Dr. Drew Pinsky.
Okay.
Would go on Stern all the time. And
that's the TV doctor.
Yeah, and
Dr.
Artie
Drew.
Was
that's
a heroin true. Addict. Artie Lang on the show was a heroin addict, and he would say shit. They wanted Artie on that show so bad that they made him an offer at one point that he couldn't. He talked about it on there, but he wouldn't say the amount. He says, "I'm not allowed to tell you the amount." This is Artie speaking. He said, "I can't tell you the amount.
Right.
Because if I did, they'd get sued because they're offering me like 20 times more than anybody on that show.
Yeah.
They want me on that fucking celebrity rehab so bad.
Right.
Blah, 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 blah." Long story short, Pinsky would get, every time he'd come in, Artie would fucking rain down on him.
Really?
Shit. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, oh, doctor, where you're on TV, like, you don't care about people. Oh, rehab. Yeah, 3 weeks rehab where you're on TV, where they don't care about you.
That was like Dr. Phil, too. Dr. Phil's the same
that
way.
That, too.
Man, where
point
where
being, though,
people.
Pinsky would have to tell him, like, bro, like, to make it back to WWE, like, WWE could be shady, But the doctoring part of everything, the medical part, has to be legit.
Has to be.
Like Pinsky would say, yes, the producers of Celebrity Rehab are fucking scumbags.
Uh-huh.
And they're dirtbags. Because Artie was like, he brought up an episode where somebody got caught smoking crack on a roof or some shit.
Right.
I don't know the show, I've never seen it. But he was like, when you're watching that, you're the doctor, you're the main guy on the show, you have to be thinking, your job as a doctor is to get these people better.
Mm.
But if you want ratings, catching a guy on the roof smoking crack, even as a doctor, in the back of your mind, you got to be like, home run!
Oh, yeah.
And Pinsky's like, no, Artie. Yeah, the producers are probably like, home run, he's smoking crack. I'm a doctor, I'm trying to get these guys better. I don't care. It's just fun, I get paid. Like, I don't care. I don't want to see a guy smoking crack on the roof. I hate that.
Right.
And Artie's like, yeah, sure you hate it. He's like, Artie, the producers probably love it. I'll admit it. What you're saying, the people who run the show,
and do you disagree they love with that.
Do you but disagree? No, I agree completely.
Right.
Which with is why Amon is probably like, yeah, maybe WWE is a shady-ass staff. Let's cut some corners to keep people working even
absolutely.
If they're hurt.
Absolutely.
We need Punk right now. He can't be on the sidelines if it's not death-threatening. Mm-hmm. You know, let's look the other way. Amon would not look the other way.
Right.
He's a doctor. Doctors
I think Amon is a pretty good doctor, and I think what CM Punk said...
They would have to fire an incredible scumbag.
Granted, there may have been...
Like Zahorian during the steroid trial?
Right.
That
right.
fucking guy was a piece of shit.
CM Punk is going to have to come out and prove that what he said on that podcast is... that he was telling the truth, and... Well,
obviously,
it's got to time out, and it's...
The reason it took this long to come out?
Right.
Punk's not going to be able to prove it. That's probably why it took so long, because they had their lawyers look through it, investigate, look at the paper trail, the paperwork, everything official, what can he prove, what is his...
Yeah.
Just his word.
Yeah.
And I think enough of it was just, well, he can't prove any of this shit, it's just his word versus ours.
Right.
He ain't got enough money to compete with us in court, so if it comes down to word versus word, he either settles, loses... Or it goes away. You know?
I think CM Punk is in some deep shit here, man. I mean, we'll have to wait and see. But he better have the proof to back up those claims on Colt Cabana's podcast. And I don't know. I don't know that he does. I don't think he does.
I wish he would do another podcast. I'll tell you that right now. That would be an interesting show.
I don't think that's happening anytime soon.
I think he learned his lesson.
I'm sure his lawyers have already advised him. Do not.
Probably, why'd you do it in the first place?
Do not address
oh,
this.
Oh, I waited until it was behind me so I could get my story.
And
I'm
I
like, what's your story this important? You
I will
stupid
bet
fuck,
you.
Why did you say
I will bet you that a guy like Ariel Helwani or somebody like that is going to ask
absolutely.
CM Punk. And I bet you, I will be willing to bet you
oh,
any money that CM Punk says, I don't really want to talk about that. You'll see, you guys, something
okay,
like that.
He
ain't gonna get into that, man, because his lawyers have already advised him. Alright, listen, Fastlane, the high points, the low points, man, let's talk about it. I thought the main event was really good. You know, Jim Ross, Chris Jericho came out. Reigns of Bryan.
Jim
I thought the
Ross?
Story. Jim Ross and Chris Jericho came out.
Oh, I thought some of the announcers. I'm like,
Jim Ross wrote a blog, and Chris Jericho on Twitter said that it was a good storytelling
match. Jim Ross write a blog? I've been looking for the last 2 days.
Maybe it wasn't a blog, but he came out on Twitter.
Yeah,
maybe it was Twitter, something like that. Where and it did. It started out slow. It started out slow, and it picked up real good at the end. A lot of people say Roman Reigns. I mean, listen, I don't think Reigns is ready on the microphone.
Bro.
He's not a great... Listen.
Daniel Bryan's the reason that match was good.
Daniel Bryan carried the match, clearly.
Okay, I thought you were about to say, he's better than people think.
Daniel Bryan
cleared the match. He's as good as we thought, but Bryan is...
But Reigns isn't this horrible, horrible worker.
He's got a couple of cool moves.
Right.
He can do them well.
Right.
As long as he's in there with a good worker who knows how to lead up to those moves.
Right.
Or do that move and then counter it with this, or do that move and then do this next.
Hey, listen.
They know what his skills are, what his ability is, what he can do well.
Mm-hmm.
They know how to, if you're a good worker like Daniel Bryan, that's what, like Shawn Michaels, people like that are born.
Right.
Because what they can do is, they're so goddamn good that they can work with somebody like Reigns. Thinks they are. He's got a good Superman punch. He's got a good spear.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a good clothesline. Pretty good body slam. All right, so I can, as long as I get him to do any of these things, if I put a clothesline here, a body slam there, and then I do this, and then he does a Superman. Like, he knows how to organize it so that what
absolutely.
He's good at
absolutely
makes the match better as opposed to, oh, this is all he can do.
Right.
You know?
Exactly.
So
exactly.
That's how good Bryan
I mean, Daniel Bryan definitely carried the match, but Reigns, for his part,
he did his part.
I thought it was a pretty good
completely.
Match, man.
Yeah.
Also on Fastlane, we had...
Sting
Triple H stuff was I thought was very well done.
Good.
I mean, Sting came out, didn't say a word. I loved when they did the sledgehammer versus the bat.
That was cool.
Triple H went out to the outside, grabbed the sledgehammer.
They're both known for.
Mm-hmm. Sting, the other part that I liked was when Sting took the bat, put it up on Triple H's throat,
yeah.
And then pointed it towards
Triple H doing the, oh, he's on me kind of thing. Yeah.
Pointed it towards the WrestleMania sign, yeah. Which, there you go, right there, is Triple H Sting at WrestleMania, which we knew for a long time, but I thought the way that it was done, and we still haven't seen Sting or heard Sting say a word at this point.
Not
and,
on storylines. Like, he's been at the 2K15.
Right. But
like
I thought the segment, it accomplished what it needed to do. Set the match up, and Sting had the bat, and it was the sledgehammer. I like that idea. And it should be the bat versus the sledgehammer. They should do something
WWE
like that. But it's
WWE
versus WWE.
The one you didn't say, the whole
like
promo
we talked about earlier.
Came out.
Right.
Before Sting came out, the whole promo was Triple H talking about, I'm WWE till I die.
But
in WWE's
defense,
we're
last night on Raw, they did build up Sting with a video package. You know, they had been hyping it throughout the show that we're going to tell you if you don't know.
The one thing I will say that worked during the Fastlane thing was that Triple H tried to, like, sneak. He tried to get him, you know, like, he was doing dastardly. He was being a heel.
Right.
So
right,
we
right.
can hate Triple H for that, but the actual storyline is almost like Triple H being so fucking selfish that he's like, well, you know what I mean? Like, you know when he does his storylines.
I love the Triple H stuff on Raw last night where he just looked pissed off and didn't say a word.
Staring,
that was
yeah.
good, man.
His mind was
that
elsewhere.
Was good.
His
that
mind
was good.
Elsewhere.
Yeah. I like that. And by the way, Seth Rollins, I mean, how far has this guy come? I was thinking to myself last night, you know, I mean, we're in a transition period trying to build up new guys, new main eventers, guys that for the next 5-10 years, I mean, granted, just, what, 4 years ago, we didn't know Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose. I really think Dean Ambrose and Roman Reigns, and especially Seth Rollins, given his current stuff with the Authority, I mean, these are guys that I look at Seth Rollins as a main eventer now.
He's,
do you?
Name a heel bigger than Seth Rollins.
Right now? I you can't.
Big Show and Kane and Seth Rollins. That's your top three heels.
Seth Rollins, I look at where if there was to be a pay-per-view, okay, this is the way that I look at new stars. Like, when you think pay-per-views, you think, all right, main event, John Cena, guys like that. And I would take Seth Rollins and I would order a pay-per-view with Rollins in the main event. Even Roman Reigns, I think, is there as a main eventer.
I would put Reigns there. I think it depends on who Reigns works with. Rollins.
Like, a guy like Ziggler is not main event. Like, you wouldn't order a pay-per-view with Ziggler.
Well, the models
in the main.
The business model
is
different. You don't need to order a pay-per-view at all. They just need to get you to sign up to the network at some point, and whatever the pay-per-view they put on is what they put on.
I tell you what. What we'll do is we'll come back. We're not going to do Fastlane top to bottom, okay? We're just going to kind of do what we've been doing here, and we'll do the same thing with Monday Night Raw. We'll do the rapid fire, and do you want to do, because we've got, I want to talk about Samoa Joe. We already talked about the CM Punk lawsuit, but I want to talk about Brock Lesnar, what happened last night at Raw. You
want to
do a phone call? I don't know. You want to do phone calls and skip rapid fire this week? There's been a lot of news that we haven't been able to get to. All right.
We can do that.
We'll skip rapid fire this week, and we'll take your live phone calls instead. We'll load up, if you've got any questions, feel free to call. We don't bite, but there's been a lot of news over the past couple of weeks, and normally I hate rushing through rapid fire week after week, where I feel like we don't give it enough time, and with the news and the rumors and all the stuff over the past 2 weeks, because we weren't here last week, we're just going to have to rush through it, and you guys ain't going to like it. So, if you got a question that you were going to put in rapid fire tonight, give us a call. The number, when we come back from the break, we'll give it out, and you guys can call up. Instead of doing the rapid fire, take your live phone calls as well this week, and then we'll talk the latest news and rumors. You guys are listening to WZR-TV Tuesdays with this guy right here in the ugly grandpa sweater. Love that sweater. Why don't you guys like that sweater? I like it a lot.
It's a nice sweater.
Yeah, I'd wear that.
It's
and
nice.
I don't wear sweaters. You know how I dress.
Nice and clean. I don't know.
All right, you guys are listening to WZR-TV with Matty Boone, Ryan Clark. We'll be back right after this. Oh, yes.
I get my sing back.
You asshole. It's something else. CM Punk!
You're just, reading about his wife.
Gotta tell ya, and you had said to me that, you think when AJ Lee's current WWE contract is up,
yeah,
she's out of there.
I don't
she's
see
gone.
Very well how she could stay. The
well,
way she's talking, the way he's talking, the way things are going.
And you brought up a good point. Let me tell you, the Oscars were the Academy Awards, the Oscars, same thing. They were on Sunday night on ABC, and Patricia Arquette, came out and won an award, got up on stage and said something. There's been a big
former
thing.
WCW World Heavyweight Champion,
David
Arquette's sister. Yeah.
Sister, okay.
Yes.
All right. No
there's Rosanna, Patricia.
Well, David was married to David Courtney Cox,
yeah.
Correct,
yeah.
From Friends.
She's hot as shit, too.
Yeah, she's still
Did you ever
good.
See the movie
Cougar.
Little Nicky with Adam Sandler?
I haven't.
Okay.
You have a friend, Little Nicky, though.
Oh, no, that's my cousin. That's a,
Oh, all right. Well, anyway, Patricia...
That's not his name. We just call him Little Nicky because he's
Patricia
young.
Arquette came
Arquette,
out.
Yeah.
And, you know, basically during her speech...
She's
saying
with
her
girlfriend, Little Nicky,
that,
you guys watching.
That, that said during her speech that in Hollywood, and there's been a big thing if you read TMZ or any of the gossip websites, that women are not being paid equal pay rates
fairly paid as men. Yeah.
In, you know, like if Jennifer Aniston and George Clooney were in the same movie.
If they were the two leading stars of a movie, Clooney would get $40 million,
Clooney,
she'd get $10 million,
right.
And they're both
so
on the same war.
Patricia Arquette came out and basically said that, you know, women's equality,
yeah.
As far as pay is concerned, where if George Clooney makes $40 million, Jennifer Aniston should make $40 million because they're both in leading roles of the same
That's
movie.
That's not true.
Just
by
an
the
example.
Way. But anyways. Yeah.
But the fact of the matter is, and this is true, and TMZ broke it because of the Sony hacking and the Sony leaks that came out.
Yeah.
It was revealed that Sony is paying their women actors a lot less than their male actors, and that is confirmed.
A lot of people got quotas, like a certain amount they have to be paid to do a certain kind of movie
right.
or a certain role, so a lot of that shit's predetermined. And a lot of it is basically how much do you draw?
Well, when you
like
sign...
Like, if George Clooney's in a movie, it's going to do this much money. If Patricia Arquette's in a movie,
listen,
it's gonna, you know...
When you sign the contract, you sign the contract. But the fact is that what Patricia Arquette is saying is... When we sign the contract should be equal to the man that I am co-starring with.
I don't know if that's exactly what she's saying.
Well, it's basically women should be
We're
paid
just not
more.
Being paid enough.
Women aren't being
I'll give
paid
you
enough.
That, yeah.
And Stephanie McMahon tweeted a photo of Patricia Arquette up on stage.
No. Patricia Arquette tweeted something, and then Stephanie replied to it.
There's a photo.
That's the...
It's a photo.
Because
Stephanie
she replied
McMahon,
to it.
Patricia Arquette came out, and there was a quote that she had, and now there's a viral image that is going around that has Patricia Arquette, and it's got the quote and her face on an image. Stephanie McMahon took that image and posted onto her Twitter account. She put up that image. She put up that image on her Twitter account. AJ Lee then replied and said to Stephanie, and this is
Straight called her out.
And said, there are divas on your current roster that have some of the highest
rated
segments. Merchandise
and segments on
and
TV,
segments
yeah.
on
and
TV yet they are getting paid a fraction of what WWE is giving them in merchandise sales and percentages and everything like that. Basically saying...
And a fraction of what the men get.
Basically saying, we're getting fucked.
Yeah.
And it's the same thing.
If Diva X sells 100 t-shirts,
yes,
she makes $20. If WWE Superstar, male Superstar, G... sells 100 t-shirts, same amount of t-shirts that she got $20
he
for.
He makes $60.
He gets $60.
You're right.
How the fuck
exactly.
is that fair? Is
it's
what
not
she's
fair.
Saying.
And
not
this,
exactly, but and, just and, as an analogy to explain.
As an example analogy,
yeah.
right. And the fact that AJ Lee tweeted that to Stephanie McMahon.
It's ballsy.
Very ballsy. And
she's
the fact
a woman,
that.
Obviously, because she's not getting paid as much as the guy.
And the fact
balls,
that. I can refer this to another male WWE superstar. And the fact that Darren Young, as of late, has come out and said, why do we go to places like Abu Dhabi where they don't allow women or the pay rates are a lot less, or gays, to be on television, but yet we go there, why do we go there, why do we support
country? Exactly what I said last, or two
Why do we
ago?
Support a country, and we go there, why? Because it's all about the money. Next thing you know,
it's a business.
Next thing you know, the primetime players are back on WWE television.
I love it.
So, you know, AJ...
Aaron Young hasn't been on Raw in months.
But I will say this.
He says that, hey, you want to be on Raw?
I know.
Yeah. Will you shut the fuck up?
I don't think it's a coincidence,
no, it's
man.
Not a coincidence.
And I think that when Darren Young's WWE contract is up, I think Young...
the statute of limitations on him, I'm gay, I can't get fired, get out of jail
free
card.
WWE's excuse would be, we didn't fire him because he was gay.
We kept him on for years after the fact.
We fired him years after the fact that he came out to TMZ, his contract was up, we didn't have anything for him, and we decided
to terminate his contract. We even tried to give him back his primetime players thing, because that's what he wanted, so we gave it to him, it didn't work. Listen,
we give it to him, and we job him out to guys like the Ascension on Raw. Oh, they beat the Ascension, right? No, last night? No, I thought the Ascension got the win last night.
They beat the Ascension. First ever loss for the Ascension in WWE.
You're right. You're absolutely right. Okay, you're right.
You think that's a coincidence?
Yeah, I know, right?
Who did the pin, by the way?
Was it Darren?
It was Darren.
Was it, dude?
It was Darren.
Was it? Listen, with Darren,
you gotta love Vince.
I am
WWE.
Telling you.
How much do you love
you.
WWE? They're so obvious.
They are so obvious. And when Darren Young's WWE contract comes,
why would we fight? Well, because he's gay. We put him back with his team and had
I am telling you, when Darren Young's WWE contract expires, when it comes up, they are not renewing that contract. I promise you.
I wouldn't guarantee that.
I don't want to guarantee it. You can never guarantee anything.
I could see them paying him just to fucking be the gay guy in the company so that they can
Where's Dan Crompton at?
Well, so that they can get away with shit. You know what I mean? If they keep the gay guy on the roster, they can do whatever they want, and if people tries to say, oh, you guys are homophobic, we've got an openly gay guy
that
we just re-signed and gave a raise to. Why? How are we openly homophobic? You know what I mean?
Where's Dan Crompton at tonight?
I don't know.
He's got the number to call us up.
He's straight out of Crompton. I don't know. That's last time
not
I heard.
Not Compton.
No, that's what
Crompton is straight out of Compton.
Well, his fantasy football team straight out of Crompton.
Straight out of Crompton.
Yeah.
Straight out of Crompton. Where's Dan Crompton at? 518-712-3070 if you guys want to give us a call tonight.
Hi, am I on the air?
518-712-3070. Give us a call right now. 518-712-3070. Talking WWE Fastlane from Sunday night.
Or Raw
UFC
Fight Night 61.
I didn't, I saw the main event, man. I saw the highlights.
Frank Mir,
I was kind of surprised, man. Frank Mir has been kind of letting me down, man. He's kind of lost.
Four in a row?
Yeah, and he beat Antonio Bigfoot Silva, I'm a big fan of.
Well, Bigfoot Silva was on TRT.
Dan Crompton ain't got the balls to call up. Fuck yourself, man.
Well,
but anyway.
Bigfoot Silva was on TRT. This is Jackie. But, all right, we'll talk about Bigfoot afterwards. All right. Have your fun.
Jackie. We missed you last week.
I know. What happened? I heard you were in the hospital. What happened?
Yeah, we're not going to get
story.
In. Not gonna get into it, but it was a rough weekend and rough week last week, but we're good now.
What's on your mind this week, Jackie Jack?
Well, I've been hearing about Little Miss China talking shit about Triple H, and you know, I'm gonna say this right now.
Uh-oh.
She's a lying dick.
Oh!
Whoa!
Hey!
She's lying. She's lying. Okay, she's just trying to start trouble for Triple H and Stephanie. Everyone knows that they were already broken up when he and Stephanie started dating. I know this for a fact. She's a liar. Point blank, a liar. She's probably high, as usual, because that was right around the time she started dating X-Pac. So she's a liar. That's why she's not taking
the money. You got a lawsuit on your way. He's a defamation of character right
slander.
There, Jack. That's slander and defamation of character.
I'm just giving my point of view.
All right.
He's joking. It's a lot.
I'm joking, but
I
listen.
I did like her when she was with Triple H, but then when she started saying all this mean stuff about Stephanie because there was, it was in the Inquirer, and I'm like, okay, time out.
Well, let me say this. Let me say this,
well,
Jackie.
I'm gonna
run down the story real quick. What Jackie's talking about, if you guys haven't seen it, it's up on WZRonline.com. But basically, the deal is, China has been making a lot of videos as of late. You know, putting them up on her Facebook
she's
and her Twitter.
Been proposed to by three different Japanese
she's
dudes.
She's got three different Japanese guys putting all these videos up.
They're
this, that, and the other
him.
Thing, and she came out and appeared on Vince Russo's podcast
the
and. The swerve and accused, you know, Triple H back in the day of abuse and
physical
abuse, and he used to hit her back in the day, this, that, and the other thing, and, you know, she's come out, I mean, there was a video a couple of days ago where she was twerking, and, I mean, listen, I
still can't get that image.
I mean,
in my head. I mean,
you guys can view these videos.
Don't
and,
do it.
You can listen to the way that she is talking in the videos, and you can look at her appearance, and you can judge for yourself, but I mean, it seems to me like she may have fallen off the wagon, and I don't know for a fact, but just the way that she is slurring her words.
She
and,
either fell off the wagon or she's looking for a payday.
She's doing this, you know, clearly. And, you know, Tammy Sitch, Sunny does it on Twitter all the time where she comes out and she'll kind of, you know, try to make a name for herself or call somebody out. But China in these videos, I mean, can all be honest here, man, she doesn't look that good in these videos. As far as, you know, slurring the words and her appearance and everything else is concerned. So I don't know. I mean, hopefully she is clean and sober. But I don't know that she is just by watching these videos. So she came out and, you know, accused Triple H of
beating
her.
And
Sean Waltman came out.
We're going to have the show soon, hopefully, if you get your shit together and get him on here.
I talked to him on Twitter the other day. All
right, so he should be on soon. But, yeah, he basically came out and said that when... Because Triple H and China used to date. Triple H cheated on China with Stephanie.
Do you want me to go tweet Sean right now and see if I can get him to call? I think I could get him to...
In the next 30 minutes, he's going to call?
If we would stay late if he called.
You could try.
Let me go try.
Call, but anyway,
run, finish up the,
he's probably doing something.
Let me see. It's
fucking middle of the night on Tuesday. Anyways, Sean Waltman, Triple H is trying to use a date. After they broke up, which they broke up because Triple H got caught cheating on China with Stephanie. This was during the angle on the... I hope that's not Waltman right there. If it is, can't answer. We still got a caller here. But anyways... yeah, so Triple H and China dated, blah, 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 blah. Triple H got caught cheating with Stephanie. That broke it up. Waltman was next to date China. And while those two were dating, China would make similar accusations. X-Pac whooped my ass. It was part of a storyline on the reality show The Surreal Life one year, where Waltman comes with, like, roses and chocolates trying to be a nice guy. And when he gets there, like, one of the Brady Bunch guys is going to kick his ass because... All China's been doing is gassing people up with bullshit stories about how, oh, he used to hit me. Typical broad shit where they get, you know, shit goes bad and what are they, oh, he raped me or, hey, oh, he hit me. So that happened, and I guess now, 15 years after the fact, she's trying to make those claims towards the game. And the reason we bring up Waltman is because he actually came out and spoke against it. He actually went on a big rant on social media the other day, and pretty much, long story short, he said, China did the same thing with me. She pretended like I beat her ass, and then ultimately admitted that it was bullshit. And even told a story, which I've heard him told many times. I've heard him told this story many times, and what's important is...
I understand that. It's just that, yeah...
Hold on, let me finish real quick, Jack. Jackie, let me finish real quick. He's told the same story about six or seven times about a story that China told him, which was that she was raped by an entire college basketball team or football, something like that, high school, whatever the fuck. She would tell this story over and over and over again in interviews and deliver it very convincingly. She'd cry, and it was, oh, it was so terrible, I got raped by all these guys. Waltman straight up says, and he's told the story many times, I've heard him say it, and he tells it the same every time, which, with a guy that has a history of drug abuse like he has, you would know you tell the same story 6-7 times in a span of 5 to 7 years, and you're on drugs throughout those whole time, and the story's always the same down to the last detail, you're telling the truth. And he pretty much said, yeah, China would tell me that same story about getting raped, and then basically admitted to me that it was total bullshit. That she was embarrassed by one of the guys, so she lied and said that they all raped her. And it was her way of defending the embarrassment that she felt. But anyways, yeah, he's in there trying to work on Waltman now. Jackie, what were you going to say? I'm sorry.
So, as I was saying, you know, okay, there's a point when you need to come out and tell the truth. And she's obviously lying. I'm not trying to start anything with her, but I can tell that she's lying. She's always said something negative about someone, then it comes back and bites her in the butt. But, you know, okay, I want to change the subject. I'm done talking about her.
Okay.
What's going on for the Andre Memorial Battle Royal? Have any more names been announced since last night?
Well, just the three from last night. The SmackDown tapings are going on as we speak. Live coverage is going on a couple of websites. Obviously, Ryan will have results, WZRonline.com, as soon as the taping's over. But as far as I've heard, no new participants have been announced for that match. Do you know his area code? Because we keep getting this guy calling over.
We don't. You can, we can get that off and then, Oh, Jackie, thanks for the call tonight. We'll answer the final question. We got a couple people that are going to, try to call in. I've got, Tammy Stitch and, Sean Waltman who are going to try to, call in here soon. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Caller, you on the air?
We don't. You can, we
turn
can
your speakers down.
Gotta turn those speakers down, man. Gotta turn those speakers down. Alright, cut them off. So like I said, guys, we're going to try to get Tammy Stitch, Sonny, and Sean X-Pac Waltman to call in to discuss the Triple H and China stuff that happened over the last couple of days. Caller, you're live on Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up? Cut him off. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. One more time. All right.
See, he's just now. You come back.
If you guys are gonna call us live, the number to call us is 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070.
And when you call, the second you hit send on your phone, turn your speakers down, because once we pick up, you're gonna be way behind and you're not gonna hear.
Yeah, you're gonna be about 30 seconds.
You try
to
call,
so
mute your shit and just listen to your phone. Oh. Anyways, well,
both of them are on Twitter right now. I don't know that Sean is on Twitter right now, but I'd like to get Sean on to try to. Is that the 573? That's all right. We'll take it. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. One more time. What's up, man?
The one thing I'm confused about with the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal is how many people are supposed to be in it with all these people supposed to be in separate matches. You're probably going to have the tag team division in action. You may see that four way for the IC title.
And I mean, you're probably going to see a lot of.
Going to have 30.
You're probably going to see a lot of double duty where guys work matches and then they're also in the battle royal. I think that's what they did last year too.
I mean, you're going to have about 30 guys.
Yeah, like Cesaro, Tyson Kidd, those kind of guys will probably be in either a tag title match and the Battle Royal, or, you know what I mean? Like, a couple of guys will be doing double duty.
It's probably going to be about 30 guys in the Battle Royal that they do at WrestleMania 31. Yeah, that's normally what it is every year. Caller, you are live on WZR TV. What's up?
What's going on, guys?
How you doing, man?
First off, I wanted to. You guys said you're watching the SmackDown spoilers.
We're following it roughly. What's up?
Yeah.
Well, whatever's happening with Brian right now doesn't look pretty good.
What do you say?
I haven't been able to. I mean, I viewed the first part of the show for SmackDown, but I haven't looked at the spoilers for you know the rest of the show or what the main event is.
Well,
I mean, if you have any details.
Is it looks like he's involved in a little Intercontinental title thing.
Who?
Daniel Bryan is?
Yeah.
They put Bryan in the Intercontinental thing?
Wow, in the IC title.
God.
So it would be
That's
who?
Horrible.
It'd be
They have Truth, Barrett,
Truth,
Ambrose, and one other guy, and now Bryan, I guess. Ziggler would be the other
one? Ziggler would be the other one. And I know that Heath Slater wanted in there as well. What are they going to do? Do you know if they're going to do a Fatal 4-Way or are there more guys?
Maybe the Memorial Battle Royal is
doing a six-man ladder match, I heard.
A ladder match?
I heard that, but I don't know where I heard that, but I heard that that's possible. And another one more thing before I let y'all go. If something does happen and Brock Lesnar just gets mad and just goes away and leaves, what happens with the belt?
I mean, if he goes away and leaves before Mania, like...
Yeah, if this is legitimate and it's like one of those things that it's not going to fix and Lesnar just decides that he's done...
I don't think it's going to turn out to be that serious. I mean, listen, they know that they need Brock for WrestleMania 31. So I think they're going to, I mean, listen, there's almost 5 weeks until WrestleMania 31. I think they're going to wind up working out their deal. But even if, I mean, let's say that Brock said, nope, I'm done. I've had enough. I quit. I mean, they would obviously strip him. I mean, it's their company. It's not Brock's company. Yeah. So they would strip him of the WWE title and do some sort of angle to crown a new champion.
Maybe they have Brock appear one last time and then Rollins does the cash in or something. Or then maybe they do the something. Maybe they end up getting The Rock and Roman Reigns.
I mean, Brock is under contract with WWE, so if he refuses to finish the dates that he has on his contract, I mean, that would be a lawsuit, and I think Brock's smarter than that to know that I've got to at least work out my final dates. So, yeah, I mean, they would bring him back, and like you said, man, they could have Rollins cash in. They could go a lot of different...
Thanks for the call, by the way.
A lot of different directions. If you guys want to call up, it's 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. I just sent tweets to both Sean Waltman and
tell
Sonny.
Tell the Brock story now that we're talking.
Yeah, while we're on the subject of Brock Lesnar, you can run it down.
All right, that's pretty basic. He took his private plane to Nashville, where Raw was, last night. He was at the building. He was in the building.
Can I just say one thing? Do you know how much it costs to own a private plane?
To fuel it?
With the gas to fuel places?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
And to keep
it
staffed. To keep...
I know.
Pilots or whatever. Yeah.
God damn it.
It's a lot. Yeah, this is a local number right here.
This might be Dan. Caller, you're live on WZR TV.
Hello.
What's up?
He said something.
You there?
Yeah, what's up, man?
He hung up. That was pretty Dan right there.
He probably hung up. Or he did hang up, but probably Dan.
He yelled something, right. Hung up. We didn't hear what he yelled. But
Brock Lesnar.
Anyways, yeah, he was at the building last night. He
took his private jet.
He essentially walked out.
Right.
We don't know why. We do know that it was... We can't confirm it, but we're pretty sure it was nothing to do with creative or a disagreement and how he was going to be booked. It was a business disagreement.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, something about his deal... There was a snag, and like they had a differing of opinions.
Brock, we should say he was
Brock
Raw.
Yeah,
like
he was there. He
okay.
was there, and he basically feels that something about his deal this, and they thought something about his deal that. They had a difference of opinion. He was pissed. He walked out.
He walked out.
So something serious is happening. We've got a bunch of calls here.
Go ahead and take ones that we haven't
neither one
you
of
know took yet. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's going on?
Hey, this is Nitro Bo here. What's going on?
Nitro Bo, man. It's been a long time since I've heard from you. What's up, bro?
Not much, man. How's everything going, bro?
It's going good, man. You know, just working it up, doing the radio show, TV show now. You know, same old.
I hear you, man. I hear you. It's great hearing from y'all, man.
You too.
I got a quick question to ask you.
Yeah.
What do you think the chances of Seth Rollins cashing in the Money in the Bank on contract at WrestleMania?
You know, I was thinking about that last night, man, is a lot of us, you know, well, at least I did for a brief time. Rollins has got that briefcase, and he's got until what? The Money in the Bank pay-per-view to be able to cash that thing in.
What is
so
that,
May? Exactly.
Yeah,
because the longest person who held that money in the bank briefcase was Edge before he cashed it in.
I think it would make sense to me. I mean, let's say that they do go and there are no changes to the WrestleMania 31 main event. Let's say they go with Roman Reigns against Brock Lesnar, and let's say that Reigns wins the title at WrestleMania, which I think is probably
and being the fact that Reigns and Rollins was part of the Shield.
Yeah,
exactly.
You
know, what's the chances of that may happen?
And start the feud
for the title with that.
That's where I'm kind of going with it, man, is you know, if Reigns were to win the WWE, you know, World Heavyweight title at WrestleMania,
You know, following that, you've kind of got that built-in feud already there with Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins, both guys, former members of the Shield. It's kind of a built-in feud that is already there. So it would make sense to do Rollins and Reigns, but if you're going to do that, I mean, a lot of times when they do the Money in the Bank briefcase stuff, they want it to be kind of a surprise. Maybe even the following night on Raw, where Reigns would win the title at WrestleMania, and then the following night on Raw, I don't know, do a rematch or something along those lines, and then, you know, when the match is over, have Rollins come out, you know, Rollins' music hits, comes out, cashes in Money in the Bank, something like that. But it, I mean, it's a built-in feud if they do Rollins and Reigns, you know.
Yeah, I mean, that would be a crazy curveball into the main event, you know, because there may be a possibility that Rollins and Orton may go at Mania, and provided who wins, should Roman Reigns win the title, that'll be easy pickings for Seth Rollins to cash in that Money in the Bank.
Well, they're not going to do. They're not going to do Rollins and Reigns at WrestleMania. They would do Reigns and Lesnar at WrestleMania. I mean, that's already.
Yeah, I'm saying. Should Reigns wins the title, you know, it could be a tremendous curveball to have Rollins go ahead and cash it in and may win the title right there at Mania.
Yeah. They could do that too. I mean, we know that they're high on Rollins. I mean, look what we've seen on Raw the last couple of months. I mean, Rollins is kind of the guy, you know?
Yeah, and probably may be the new face. I mean, after all, he had that Money in the Bank briefcase for this long, and like I said, Edge was the longest person to have that briefcase before he cashed it in and won the title.
Who was the only guy that cashed in Money in the Briefcase and didn't win? It was two people, two
Cena,
guys.
It was John Cena.
Sandow was the other guy, right?
Sandow was the other one, yeah.
It was Sandow and John Cena.
Okay, all right, no doubt.
Sandow never cashed in the Money in the Bank briefcase.
He did. He cashed in on Cena and lost, right?
Did Sandow cashed in it?
He cashed on Cena and lost on Raw the night after Mania, I believe.
Yeah, and I know Cena lost his to CM Punk because he gave him a week's notice before he cashed it in.
Right.
You know.
Right. All right, buddy. Hey, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Good hearing from you.
Hey, great hearing from you, man. Y'all take care, all right?
All right, be good, bro.
Hey, man, like that sweater, bro.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, be good, man. Be good, bro.
Talk to you later.
All right. If you guys want to call up, because we're not doing the rapid fire tonight, you guys can do so. It's 518-712-3070, 518-712-3070. If we can get Sean Waltman or Tammy Sitch, you guys can check my Twitter account. I sent it directly right over the main feed. No DMs, no inbox messages. I sent it to them. They got the phone number.
So they're not calling anyway. So what else we got for the show here?
Maybe this is them right now. Caller, you are live on WZR-TV. We'll try this again. What's up?
Yeah, it's T-Bone.
It's who?
T-Bone. He hung up and said he was T-Bone.
T-Bone?
I didn't click anything. He
is that
not,
a joke?
He said it's T-Bone.
Is this supposed to be a joke?
And he hung up. You know anybody in New York? All
we haven't done
area?
This tonight. WZRonline.com.
.com/chat
WZRonline.com/chat Get back to the Lesnar story,
what's
man.
Trending worldwide. Read the red. Read the red.
Trending worldwide. Boone's old man sweater. Yeah, right. Yeah, right. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's going on?
Turn your speakers down.
You got to turn those speakers down, man. What's up? Nah, they're hanging up tonight.
He
what's the deal?
And then hung up.
Nobody wants to talk to us tonight. What's
scared,
up? What's up here tonight? All right, so Brock Lesnar. So, did he wind up walking out of Raw last night? Do we know that?
Lesnar?
He walked
out before the show. Yeah, he was pissed about something regarding business between he and WWE and just left.
Business between WWE, but it's not creative related.
Nah, wasn't like, we want you to do this. He's like, no, fuck that. He was more like, you owe me this money, or I'm not supposed to do this, or...
I got a photo of Brock this morning in Nashville, Tennessee, taking a photo with a couple of kids. So we know that following Raw last night, despite the fact that he had his private jet right there in Nashville,
he was still in Nashville, Tennessee this morning. We know that now, as of right now,
home right now,
as of right now, he is back home in Minnesota.
Minnesota, not Canada, but Minnesota, yeah.
Right, he is back home in Minnesota right now, so he's not at the SmackDown tapings. We know that there was a creative or production meeting today.
Okay.
At the SmackDown tapings, and
yeah,
Vince McMahon briefly addressed
but he didn't get specific about it.
But didn't get a specific. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Caller, you're on the air. You there? Caller?
Francesco Alberti here. I'd like to talk to you about God.
Jesus.
God damn it.
Boy, we got prank calls. We got people hanging up on us tonight.
You like my joke?
I did.
He said, I'd like to talk to you about God. I said, God damn it. No.
That was good. That was good. All right, if you guys want to call us up, it's 518-712-3070. What do you think about Samoa Joe?
I think that's a very interesting story.
I got to say this.
I think it's very telling of where the DNA is in their.
I agree. I agree. And the reason that Boone says that is Samoa Joe, I mean, if you guys have been following the websites, TNAWrestlingNews.com, all TNA news, nothing but TNA, Samoa Joe is known as a locker room leader in TNA and has been known on overseas tours. I mean, there was a story 6, 8, 10, maybe even a year ago about Samoa Joe. The TNA roster was on a bus. They were headed to the arena.
How long ago did you say this was? Because this was
not a year ago.
No, this was a couple months ago. This was a European tour.
Was it a couple months ago? It was a European tour.
This was a European tour at the end of last year.
At the end of last year.
And everybody's morale was up, and Joe had this
speech
on the
bus. And Joe was on a bus and basically cut a promo.
Not that long ago.
To the roster on the bus, basically saying
TNA. I'd say 6 months ago, maybe.
TNA is going places, and this is the place to be, and we all need to stick together. He was known as a guy that, in meetings with the roster backstage at the Impact tapings, was known to stand up and speak to the roster and basically give a pep talk.
I've been here a long time, and how things work. Listen, they let Hulk Hogan, Eric Bischoff, the owner and founder, Jeff Jarrett, AJ Styles, the face of the company. Samoa Joe, the other face of the company. I could go on forever of the names that they've either let go or those names decided this place is not where I want to be anymore.
Yeah.
That tells you that, all right, this was before they got their new deal. All those names except Joe. And now that they've got their new deal, even the last remaining, this is TNA
locker room
through
leaders.
Yeah, TNA through and through kind of guy.
Yeah.
The last guy that's really TNA.
Kurt Angle only signed a 1-year deal.
That's because he's finished his career.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
He, one more year and I retire. You know, but Joe's a young guy.
And then you look at things,
he's back in ROH, by the way. You saw that.
ROH announced that Samoa Joe was going
to
be back today.
Back to
They got AJ Styles back.
13th anniversary
Jesus.
Pay-per-view
if
coming
we
up. Can
get
Cena Real.
If we can get Tyler Black, Seth Rollins, it's not going to happen. And
Zayn and Steen back.
Put El Generico and Kevin Steen back in there. You throw CM Punk back in there.
Let's get a little low-key going again.
You know what I mean? My God, ROH can become something, man.
Yeah, man.
Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Hey, Ryan, it's Barbara Means. Listen, I got a question to ask you about the shirt I bought from you.
The shirt?
The
t-shirt?
Yeah,
alright, what's up?
Yeah. It's a t-shirt I bought from you guys. Did you ever send it out to Chris Brown?
Chris Brown.
Did you not receive it?
He never received it, he said.
Send me an email ASAP.
I'll send you two of them.
Webmaster of ProWrestlingScoops.com. Yeah, I'll take care of you. If you guys, I mean, everybody. Everybody should have their t-shirts by now. They were all,
I watched them send them.
When did you order?
I painted you on the 9th of January.
Right.
9th.
Well, look
February.
It up after the show. Make sure it's true.
Yeah.
And if you didn't get it, apologies from us. And I've watched him and his sister pack them up in boxes and send them.
Yeah, it should have been,
if you didn't get it, we'll send you a couple of them to make up for it.
Yeah, yeah, go to, send me an email, webmaster@prowrestlingscoops.com. I'll double check. I'll double check.
Put the date in there so he can look it up.
I'll double check PayPal and make sure that we got the money. And if you didn't get it, we'll give you a tracking number next time around. But everybody should have had their t-shirts by now. So.
Okay.
All right, webmaster@prowrestlingscoops.com. All right?
Anything else?
All right, thanks a lot, bro.
All right. All right, be good, man. All right, Yeah,
no, I can vouch for that. I've watched you and your brother pack them up and box them. You're looking for the right sizes. You had a big notepad full of addresses written down. I watched it.
Everybody should have their T-shirts.
Believe me, I'd love
if you didn't get
right
the T-shirt, but webmasterfirmsecurity.com. But everybody...
He never paid me regarding the shirts. We had a bet on...
Well, we had the bet, but...
sell.
No, everybody should have their T-shirts. Yeah, I believe so.
Should have.
Yeah. Anyways, give us a call, 518-712-3070. We're going to be here for about 15 more minutes. But Samoa Joe, I mean, listen, and then not only that, but the ratings for Destination America,
yeah.
I mean, week after week, drawing like 400,000,
500,000 people. You could draw more, literally, if you did the show on YouTube every week.
You could.
You'd get about 600,000, 700,000 on YouTube.
There are 400, 500,000 people that are watching Impact on a weekly basis. Now, that doesn't include TiVo and everything else, but when your advertisers aren't looking at that sort of thing, you know? So, caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Yeah, this is not really a wrestling question, more boxing related. What are your thoughts on Pacquiao and Mayweather?
There you go.
Mayweather's a great question, man. As far as the announcement itself that the fight's made, May 2nd, Las Vegas, it's official. It's finally going to happen. Thanks for the call. He hung up. It's official.
It is official.
We posted it a couple days ago, yeah.
Is it 5 years too late?
It's definitely a couple years too late. But just like Mike Tyson, Lennox Lewis, just like Pacquiao, De La Hoya, Mayweather, just like fucking, you know, you go through the history of matches that happened. The prime one that comes to mind is Mike Tyson, Lennox Lewis.
Mm-hmm.
And it's similar because...
That's where Lennox knocked him... that was Buster Douglas.
Lennox knocked him out too. But what's similar about that fight and this fight, and that's why I use it as a comparison, it was about 6-7 years after it should have happened, when it would have really been a big deal. It was still... Big deal competitive, still drew huge.
Yeah.
What's interesting is that... caller, hang one second. What's interesting about the Pacquiao Mayweather thing in relation to the Tyson Lewis thing is that Tyson was Showtime.
Right.
Lewis was HBO. Right
Mayweather
now,
Showtime.
Yes, Mayweather is Showtime and Pacquiao's HBO. So we have to have these two. It'd be like WWE and WWE working together to do Austin versus Goldberg.
Right.
So it's very unique. In that sense, and it's after the fact, like Tyson Lewis, so it's very similar. Anyways,
our agency has been granted extraordinary powers in the pursuit of terrorists and other threats to national security. I'm sure you're aware of this. That includes the ability to monitor electronic and digital information exchange.
Anyways, anything that comes from 518, don't
okay.
but listen, I mean, I was talking with Dan.
Well,
Dan Crompton. We ain't got the balls to call
got,
up tonight. Well, it was still, dude. 518-712-3070.
You just told me not to answer any 518.
Listen, 5 years ago, before Pacquiao lost, I know Dan's number, though, so when it pops in, it's 410. So anyway.
410, that's Maryland, though.
573-410.
Oh.
Jesus. But 518-712-3070. Listen. 5 years ago, when everybody wanted this fight to happen back then.
Yeah.
Then Pacquiao comes out, and he loses two fights. Now, granted, one of those fights was a really, really shitty decision. Okay?
518 again. Different number, but...
Fuck it. But
he didn't lose to Timothy Bradley.
Timothy Bradley, that's the one that
now,
I'm talking
Marquez
about.
Did knock his ass out.
Right.
But Marquez was probably on PEDs, too, when he did it.
Right.
You don't really take away from Pacquiao for that.
The problem is Pacquiao in the last 5 years, I thought 5 years ago, and I didn't think that he had much of a shot to defeat Mayweather. I mean, Mayweather...
Parnelli's in the house, apparently. He said he's close enough that he could drive to our house and knock on the door.
There you go. We're in Waterville, man. Waterville, New York. But listen... I mean, I thought Pacquiao back in the day, I thought that Pacquiao...
You always picked Pacquiao over Mayweather.
I always thought...
Never.
I mean, Mayweather is so good. He's so good that you don't want to bet against him, right? You don't want to bet against him.
You do not bet against Mayweather.
So I got to go Mayweather, but who do I want to win? I'm Pacquiao.
Who do I want to win? Mayweather.
Yeah.
Who do I pick to win? Mayweather.
Yeah, Mayweather's
probably gonna murk him. Now listen, he's not gonna beat his ass. He will beat him in the decision, and Pacquiao will probably go home without a mark on his face. But Mayweather will make him look retarded, most likely. That's my opinion.
Probably. Mayweather is so
fast.
Here's
your 573 right here.
Yeah, it's the same guy. Caller, you're live on WZR-TV. What's up?
Yeah, was there ever any confirmation on what the wrestling event was going to be held at City Field this year?
Yeah, it's going to be a Legends of the Ring event. It's going to feature guys like Ric Flair, Jake the Snake Roberts. It's going to feature a lot of, huh? Yeah, it's going to feature a lot of legends and people like that. Where Legends of the Ring, I mean, they've ran shows in the past. I mean, listen, they're running Citi Field in New York City. Okay, I mean, it's a baseball stadium. It holds 70,000 people, and we know, we know that when TNA of all, I mean, the second biggest promotion in America, I guess Ring of Honor and TNA are kind of right there now.
Yeah.
But, when TNA holds events at, minor league baseball stadiums, they draw 1,000 people or 1,200 people or 750 people, something like that. So I feel like, all right, Citi Field, you're going to do a Legends of the Ring event. Sure, you're going to have guys like Ric Flair, Jake the Snake Roberts, people like that. But you're renting out the entire stadium. You're renting out Citi Field, which is going
to
cost a lot of money.
A
lot of money.
Mets Stadium, right? Or
it is. It
what
is
it used
the
to
Mets
be called?
Stadium.
It
is
something different than
Citi
Field.
Shea Stadium.
Shea Stadium.
But you're going to rent out that. I mean, you're going to pay a shitload of money, and you're probably going to have what, 1,000 people in attendance. You know. I mean, you're gonna have 1,000 people in attendance, and you're renting it out an entire MLB baseball stadium. It doesn't make a lot of sense to me. So,
long story short, Mayweather beats the fucking shit out of Peck. Yeah,
Mayweather beats the shit out of Peck. I
love that you predict that now, like it's so sure.
I know.
A couple years ago, you couldn't have convinced us. It was one of those where we would argue on the air.
No,
he would be so sure he's right, and I would tell him, dude, Mayweather would walk, dance. Circles.
You know why?
He would outbox him. Pacquiao would never touch him. Mayweather, touch, move.
You know why?
Yeah, why?
Because I was a big, big fan back in the day of Pacquiao. Okay?
Me too, but
and
I
can't stand Mayweather.
There's something about
Mayweather
that
I can't stand, man.
It's
the
job. He's
the attitude.
Best deal on the business.
It's the ego. You know what I mean?
He's
the best deal
on the business. You take boxing, you take MMA, you take pro wrestling, you will not find a better deal than Mayweather.
I know. Caller, you're live on WZR-TV. Turn those speakers down real quick.
Comedycalls.com.
Oh, this is lame, dude. Your jokes are lame, man.
Don't even address it. Move on.
It sucks,
what else
dude. 518-712-306. If you're going to do a prank call, like, make them good.
You're giving them more
make
attention.
Make them good, though.
You're giving them more attention than
make
them
good, dude.
I agree.
Those suck. 518-712-307-0. 518-712-307-0. We got a couple more minutes to be taking your live phone calls. I tried to get Waltman and Sonny to call in, but they must not. I mean, Waltman's a Twitter mark. And
yeah,
by the way, Waltman came out.
A guy with a life. He's probably not in front of Twitter right now.
Waltman came out and did deny China's claim.
I told the whole story where you were going.
Oh, did
you? Yeah.
All right, yeah. I mean, he came out and said no.
That's what I was bringing up, yeah. Like, he basically said China did the same thing that she's doing with Triple H with me, and then basically admitted that she was full of shit when it was all said and done.
What do you think of China? With those
well, I told you, there was a story, I'm sure you know about it, where she claims that an entire men's basketball team raped her,
uh-huh.
And then admitted it was bullshit.
Right,
so
right.
She got
right.
embarrassed by a guy that didn't like her. Oh, he raped me! You know,
right.
Don't do that.
There are some crazy chicks out there. Yeah. Caller, you're live on WZR-TV. What's up?
What's up, guys? Jordan Paveo.
How you doing, man?
Jordan Paul Paveo.
The champ.
I just wanted to know what you guys thought of Rhino and Brian Kendrick returning.
That's right. Rhino was debuted NXT. Of NXT last week.
Oh, that's right.
And who
that's
was the
right.
other name he said? Brian Kendrick?
Brian Kendrick.
Yeah, he was the guy that trained in Shawn Michaels Academy, I believe, with Daniel Bryan.
You know what? I like it because you've got at what academy?
The Shawn Michaels Texas Wrestling Academy.
Kendrick did?
I believe it was Brian Kendrick, Daniel Bryan, and Lance Cade were like the three standouts.
All right.
I think.
But, yeah, both of them returned at NXT at the TV tapings this last week, I believe it was. I like it. You know, you've got guys that have been...
Last Wednesday, because I walked to the store when I came back.
Right.
The Rhino thing was up.
You've got guys that have worked on the main WWE roster in you know, Rhino and Brian Kendrick. Both of them have been to the main roster.
Yeah.
And I feel like when you bring guys like that, they were never major name stars on the main WWE roster.
Rhino was a decent deal. I mean, he was the last ever ECW World Heavyweight and TV champion.
Yeah, but when you've got guys like
that,
and you bring them down to NXT, even off air, where they can talk to the guys in NXT and tell them what they need to do to better themselves for when they get to the main roster.
Essentially, that's what Rhino was doing. He was there to help with the guys, and they said, well, while you're here, let's have you do a couple matches on TV.
Are they doing Rhino and Bull Dempsey?
Probably. Or or Baron Corbin. Yeah.
But it's going to do nothing but help guys in NXT to have guys with experience down there.
Yeah, on the job training.
Talk to, right? Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Yes, I'm watching you right now, and I'm just trying to get a clarification on someone was talking about the Cena cash-in.
Uh-huh. The Rollins cash-in.
You know what? I think it was you. What did you say was the reason that Cena was unsuccessful with that match?
Yeah, there was Cena and Sandow that unsuccessfully cashed in. What's your question? I'm having trouble.
No, the one, Cena, when you tried to cash in on Punk, had said something. I can't remember what it was.
What about it?
Why he was unsuccessful.
Okay.
He was.
All right, thanks for the call. He had a real question in there, but I don't know what the fuck he was talking about.
There were two guys that had the Money in the Bank briefcase, and they were both unsuccessful in...
He had a point to make about when Cena didn't cash in successfully, but I couldn't tell what the hell he was trying to say. It sounded like he had, like, what is it called, MS?
I don't know. Don't,
multiple
don't
sclerosis?
Go there. Don't go there.
Breaking Bad, I'm thinking of, because he's got the guy with the
So what?
What's this called?
Multiple
no, when you,
sclerosis.
When you break your leg and you need, not nunchucks. What the fuck?
Crutches.
Crutches. Crutches. Yeah.
Anyway.
Where the hell did I get that at?
So listen, we came back this week. It wasn't the greatest show, but what are you going to do? We're back, you know, we're a little bit rusty.
Very
a little rusty.
Show.
We didn't do the rapid fire tonight, but a little bit rusty. But we came back this weekend.
I don't
feel
good about this one at all, man.
I got to tell you. The last couple of weeks around here have not
been rough, man.
They've been pretty rough. And then something that I don't want to get into, but
don't even bring it back up. Go ahead.
About a half hour or an hour before we came on here, don't want to get into it.
And then what?
Going to address it, but it really put me in a ticked off mood tonight. So anyway, so we still came on here and we did it. Boone tried to get me out of that mood, but I'm still in it. And what are you going to do, man? What are you going to do? Nice guys never win.
No.
But anyway, thanks to everybody that came out tonight. A lot of you guys showed up later in the show tonight, but we tried to get Sean Waltman and Tammy Sitch. Tammy came out, sent a tweet out yesterday. Poor Dolph Ziggler is backstage at Raw getting ribbed by the boys yesterday. Basically said that, somebody asked Tammy on Twitter, who would you rather fuck, Randy Orton or Dolph Ziggler? And Tammy says, well, since I've already had Dolph, I guess I'd go Randy. And then Tammy is all over my Twitter account right now saying, I've got a photo of Dolph Ziggler sleeping in my bed that I'm going to send you. She said, I need your email again.
Did you give it to her?
And when I went out there, I sent her my email earlier in the day today.
Do you have a picture?
I don't have it yet.
She has it coming?
Apparently.
I'll post the fuck out of that, honestly.
So, apparently she's going to send me a photo when she finds it.
So,
and
Ziggler fucks
when I went out there.
Ass, so he just hits everybody.
He hits anybody.
Anybody that's a story. Like, oh yeah, you saw that chick on TV? Yeah, fuck it.
Alright, one more call.
One more call?
Could be Waltman.
Looks
Tammy.
Like it's going to be bullshit, but go ahead.
It's probably going to be BS, but whatever. Caller, you're live on WZR. What's up?
Yes, I was calling the world above the... in the kitchen, and you cut me off before I could...
Go ahead, man. Make your point. I'm sorry.
I want to know, what was the reason that you gave for why Cena was unsuccessful with that match?
Alright, listen, there were two guys that cashed in Money in the Bank, right?
Wyatt just now.
And
yes,
the two guys. Okay, alright, repeat the question one more time, bro.
Alright, the cash in Cena and CM Punk, that was in 2012.
Okay.
And I don't know if it was you or the person who's calling. What was the reason given as to why Cena was unsuccessful?
Okay, why was Cena unsuccessful in cashing in?
They wanted him to be the first guy to cash in and not win the title. Because Cena was the first, Sandow was the second.
Okay.
There's been two to date that cat.
Now, I went on a website that says that he lost from a disqualification. If memory serves me right, the Big Show knocked Cena out, which caused a disqualification.
Right. We would have to go back and we would have to check the history on that. But.
Yeah, I'm looking on the internet right now.
Okay. All right. We'll go back and we'll get back to you on that next week. Okay, man.
Okay.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
We'll have to go back and we'll check the history on the two guys that cashed in Money in the Bank and failed. Caller, you're live on WZR-TV. Last final call of the night. What's up?
This is the final call of the night.
Is this Tammy?
This is Tammy.
What up, Tam?
What's going on?
Nothing. What's up with you?
Nothing. I just went on the computer and I saw the phone number on my Twitter feed, so I figured, what the hell?
Well, we're staying late now. We're staying late. So what's going on?
Oh, nothing. I just got home from a nice dinner with my sister. I had a great workout today and, just chilling.
There you go.
I was just about to get in the shower when I looked at the computer and I saw the number. I'm like, all right, I'll prolong the shower.
Just throw
your bones. But instead, I literally was undressed and the shower was running and I looked at the computer, so I'm actually sitting here on the couch naked.
There you go.
I swear to God, I was just about to get in the shower.
So listen, we're going to...
We got a naked Tammy Sitchin.
We got a naked Sonny here tonight, right? No, listen... Listen, guys, for those of you guys in the chat room, we're going to stay a little bit late because we got Tammy on here. I didn't know if you were going to call or not, but we're good to go.
I swear to God, because I just walked in, got undressed to get in the shower because I didn't shower after the gym. I went right to dinner, but then I looked at the computer, so here I am, naked on the couch on the phone with you.
There we go. Lucky us. So listen, we got a lot to talk to you about.
Oh, Jesus. Well, I'm not going to talk about everything, I'll tell you.
You're stirring up that drama on Twitter, huh?
No, I swear to God. You know what I did? I said hello. Somebody said, this is Dean Ambrose's Twitter. I'm like, all right. So I said hello. That's all I did. I said hello. And like a million freaking wacko chicks are going off on me. And I'm like, oh, my God. I didn't say, hey, Dean Ambrose, I want to start your talk. I just said, hello. I mean, whether it was his real Twitter or not, whether he goes on or not, somebody said it was. So I just said, hello. That was it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. The exact words were, hey, handsome. And I got eaten alive by these psycho bitches. It was hysterical.
I know. People are crazy. No, people are crazy on Twitter, man. Like I see it all the time.
I hate Twitter because of it. I really do.
No, it's crazy. There's just crazy, crazy people out there, man.
I've got 44,000 followers on there, too. So, I get attacked in every direction.
Yeah. So, listen... We got to talk about. No, listen. There's two things that I definitely want to talk to you about. So we got let's go back to what was it like 2 weeks ago, right? We had Ashley Massaro, right?
Mm.
Yeah.
She said.
So.
What about it?
No. So listen. So I don't know how this whole thing started, right? But we had Ashley on there, and you said something about her being an escort, right? And which we've heard, listen, we put it up on the website back in the day. Ashley's been known as kind of an escort.
Well, here's the thing. Somebody said something about, my Skypes and stuff like that. I'm like, oh, okay, so I can't do something on a computer, but somebody like Ashley Massaro can be a high-priced escort. I even put her over and said high-priced escort. I didn't
compliment.
Her,
yes.
I didn't call her a quarter streetwalker. I didn't call her a hooker. I said high-priced escort. I gave her the best possible title there was.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And that's all I said. I said, so she can go and, you know, be a high-priced escort, but I can't go online through, you know, a Skype video chat and talk to somebody. That's wrong. But she can be a high-priced escort, and that's okay. You know, and that's all I said.
Right.
And, like, she went off, the world went off, and I'm like, bitch, truth hurts, huh? You know, just admit. See, I'm the most honest person you will ever know. You'll ever meet. You ask me something, I tell you the truth. I don't hide anything. I'm not ashamed of anything I do, and I put it all out there. But for somebody whose picture was on the escort website and it was obviously it was her, I mean, everybody knew it was her, and then she goes and denies it. I'm sorry. Just admit you did it. Who gives a shit? Nobody's gonna look down at you for it. You fucking did it. It's over. And just, you know, move on with your life.
Well, you had said that's not me.
You had said
I can't go on Skype and do this and that. Did she say something first, and this was your response to her, or did you so-called fire the first shot?
I just used an example. That's all it was. I'm like, so I can't do something, you know, just on a computer. Well, I'm not touching a soul. I'm not doing anything with anyone personally. I'm not meeting up with people. I'm not doing anything like that. Just video chats, and, you know, that's so wrong. But she can, you know, sell herself for whoever, whatever she was doing. I don't know. But that's okay.
I remember putting it up like a year or two ago that there were photos that came online where she was on an escort site or something like that, and it was like a high priced, you know, like a high end escort type thing.
Right.
No, there's
when I made the statement, like I said, I gave her the credit of being the high price. I didn't say, you know.
Right.
Low class streetwalker, you know.
Right.
I gave it the best possible title there is.
Right.
And I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. You know, she can do whatever she wants to do, and nobody really has the right to judge her. I was just using an example that people are accepting that, but then they're, you know, pounding me because I'm on a computer. It just makes no sense.
All right, so check this out, right? So we got the Skype thing going on, right? And we can plug that, yeah. Right? What's the we'll talk about the Skype here in just a minute, right? But, like, what goes on during the Skype chats? Let's be honest, right?
Walk us through a typical Skype chat.
What happens? I mean, does some stuff happen there, or is it just like, yeah, you and I, we're chatting, we're just having a conversation, or is there more to that if people pay a little bit more?
PayPal your payment, you'll find out.
Oh, is that what it is? All right.
Hey, I'm a businesswoman, okay? I don't give anything away.
All right, listen, I'm going to be honest with you. Listen, there's been some photos out there. I don't know if people are screen capping them or if they're taking, I don't know. I don't know what they're doing, if they're using Photoshop or whatnot. But there's been some photos out there, let's be honest, right? And they've been put up on Ashley Mazzaro. Ashley took one of those photos and put it up on our Twitter account. Is it the real? I mean, what's going on?
Okay, wait a minute. Let me ask you this. Didn't she do Playboy?
No, she did. She did. No doubt.
Yeah, aren't there naked pictures out there of her, too?
There are.
Who gives a shit? It's a naked body. Who cares?
Are there naked photos of you out there from Skype?
I remember wrestling vixens.
No, I remember that.
Wrestling vixens, like, 14 years ago. Yeah, there's naked pictures.
Yeah, her and Missy Hyatt did a website together.
All right, yeah.
I was a member.
I remember that. All right.
A year or two.
They got my money.
There's been naked pictures of me on the internet since the year 2000. Do you think I care now if I, you know, I flash somebody on Skype?
I know. Yeah.
I honestly don't care. I'm proud of my body. I'm working my ass off in the gym. I'm in the best shape I've been in years right now.
You look good.
I went through cancer. I gained 40 pounds after my cancer surgery. I've lost it all, and I've lost even more than when
that's
I started. Great. I've tightened up. I've toned up. I'm busting my ass every day. I mean, I'm proud of myself, and I'm not a prude person. I am an exhibitionist. I have to say that. I've always been. So I see nothing wrong with, you know, showing us a little skin. I really don't.
I will say this, man. There was about a year ago, Tammy did send me an email, and she sent, you know, you sent the doctor stuff. So the whole cancer thing that a lot of people, I mean, I know a lot of people were on you about it on Twitter saying, you know, she's faking cancer, this, that, and the other thing.
Yeah,
listen,
Jesus,
I saw the doctor stuff that you sent me in an email, and I put it up on the websites too. So I know that was the real deal. You're doing good now, though, right? Because you look, I mean, there was some photos that you put up from the gym, I think. It was like a UFC gym or something like that. You look good.
No, that's just my regular gym and my MMA school right next door. Actually, it's not a UFC gym, but those pictures were just from this weekend.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and I'm just going to get in better shape as time goes on. I plan to have abs by summer.
So,
it is what it is. But with, I mean, I went to 2 surgeries to get rid of all my cancer. 2 surgeries. And people had the balls to say I was faking cancer.
I know. What kind of cancer did you have?
The paperwork. I had stage 1 squamous cell carcinoma of the cervix.
Oh, shit. My sister had the same thing. So how are you doing right now? Is it all behind you?
No, I'm great. When they gave me the offer of the first surgery, they said we can just cut the cancer out of the cervix.
And
if you ever want to try to have kids and try to, you know, save your uterus and everything like that, I said, you know what? I don't want to take the chance. Because cervical cancer can spread really easily into your bloodstream, and you get leukemia, or your lymph nodes, and you get lymphoma.
I said,
take it all out. So they took my cervix, my uterus, within 2 surgeries, they took my cervix, my uterus, all the ligaments that used to hold my uterus to my pelvic bones, 26 pelvic lymph nodes, and my appendix.
Wow. So you're good to go now. You are completely...
Oh, yeah, it's completely, I have my ovaries, so I have my hormones,
there you go.
Menopause or anything like that, and if I ever want to have kids, which I probably don't, because I'm not a kid person, I'm a dog person,
She's a dog person.
I can always get my eggs extracted and fertilized with somebody, if I ever find somebody that I see fit as a father, and my best friend said she would surrogate for me, so there's always a possibility, that's why I kept my ovaries, but other than that, it's gone. And you know what the best thing about it?
What's that?
No more periods.
No more periods. The sentence is over. She said the sentence is finally ended. There's no more period. No more commas. No more semicolons.
Nothing. Hey, Tim.
The best part of it.
Tim, listen. I want to do something because we're gonna get out of here right now. I want to plug the Skype and I want to plug anything else, the Twitter and everything else. I want to have you, I got so much more to ask you, and I want to have you on for like a full show, you know what I mean?
For like an entire hour.
So I want to have you back, because I got so much to ask you about. I want to ask you about the Dolph Ziggler and the, you know, all the stuff.
I'll tell you right now, it happened. We were talking, real quick, like, I'll make it
no,
real
go
quick.
Oh, we'll make time no, for that, go ahead.
What?
I said, we have time for that story, go ahead, yeah.
Okay, he found me on Facebook. Okay, he found me.
Okay.
So we started flirting through Facebook. Then we exchanged numbers and we started texting. Then we started talking, and you know, we it was heavy like sex texting.
How long ago was this, by the way?
Whenever that Miami pay-per-view was, what year was that? 2010 or 11?
Okay, so a couple years ago.
It was right before my Hall of Fame. So 2010.
There you go. Okay,
so,
go ahead.
So we were, you know, we were flirting like, I mean, the texts we were sending to each other were insane. So about 2 weeks before that Miami pay-per-view, I realized, I'm like, wait, they're in Miami. I was hosting a pay-per-view party in Fort Lauderdale at a sports bar.
Yes.
That night. So I texted him. I said, Nick, you're not going to believe this. I'm going to be an hour from you in 2 weeks. He goes, what? I said, yeah, you got the pay-per-view in Miami. I'm hosting a pay-per-view party at a sports bar in Fort Lauderdale that night. He goes, I'm so there. That was his exact words. So I said, all right. So we were, you know, making plans about, you know, what we're going to do. And the day of the show, it was like an hour before his match, and I'm at the pay-per-view party, and we're still texting each other, even though he's supposed to be getting ready for his match. And I said, listen, I said, when you come out on that ramp, I want you to wink at the camera so I know you're thinking of me. And if you watch back that pay-per-view, he walks out, he winks at that goddamn camera. Because I told him to. So I'm watching, and the promoters that hired me down there, like, I told them everything. I said, watch for the wink. And there it was, and the whole bar popped. Because I told everybody to watch for it. So, you know, we're watching the match, and I see him get kicked in the head. He busts his lip open, and I'm like, oh, that looks like really, really sick, because Loki's a mess. So I texted him. It was, like, right after his match, and I texted him. I said, listen, I saw you might have gotten hurt. It's okay if you can't make it tonight. It's not a big deal. He texts me back about 20 minutes later, and he goes, oh, hell no, I'm not missing out on this. I said, okay. So he calls about a half an hour later, and he's like, well, you know, the doctor saw me. I have a concussion. And they don't want me to drive anywhere. They want me to stay at the TV hotel tonight and just rest. I said, you know, it's fine. He goes, fuck that. I'm coming to see you. I was like, all right. So after the show, he gets in his car. He drives up. He even stops for Excedrin for his head because he had a headache. Finally gets to my room, comes in, and it's on. We were basically active, I would say, until about 5 o'clock in the morning.
Really?
And, really? Yeah. About five o'clock. It was a marathon. 5 o'clock in the morning.
So, it is a marathon.
I had to leave for the airport at 7, so I'm like, all right, let's get like 2 hours of sleep, and I gotta get to the airport. So we basically doze off for 2 hours. I set my alarm. I get up at 7. I don't even shower. I just put my hair in a ponytail, and I'm like, all right, I gotta go to the airport. He goes, do you mind if I just stay here and sleep? I'm like, no, not at all. It's no big deal. You know, my room's paid for by the promoter. No problem at all. He's like, okay. By now, when his hair dries, it turns into a huge blonde afro. So he's laying on my bed, and he's got this huge blonde afro, and he goes back to sleep as I'm in the bathroom packing up my stuff, brushing my teeth, whatever. So I go back out, and he's on his belly, and his arms are extended, and his head is turned towards the window, and his back is, like, towards me. So I grab my camera, and I snap a picture. I'm like, all right, you know, it's cute. He's laying in bed. He's got the blonde afro. I take a picture. I go over. I wake him up. I kiss him on the cheek. I tell him I'm leaving. He's like, okay, you know, I had fun. Actually, I have to tell you, the whole time we were doing this, he's like, oh, my God, you were on my wall when I was a teenager. I can't believe this is happening. You were my fantasy, blah, 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 blah. I used to whack off to you all the time.
Oh.
It's the typical stuff that younger guys say to me. So, like, here I am thinking that Dolph Ziggler was going to be a conquest. Instead, it was, like, one of the easiest lays I ever had.
Yeah, you were his conquest. What are you talking about?
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, so then I left and I went to the airport. As I'm at the airport, he checks. He's like, all right, I'm awake and I'm going to leave. He's, do I have to check you out of the room? I'm like, no, don't worry about it. Just leave. And that was it. And then we still talked after that for a while. And then we eventually, you know, just faded off.
My
but
God,
it happened.
My God, that woman can tell a story.
I fucking love you, Tim.
My God, that woman can tell a story.
I love you.
That's the greatest thing I've ever heard.
It was a lot of fun, and he's really good, but it's crooked.
So
it's crooked. You're
gonna gloss over that? She says it's crooked.
It's crooked?
Yeah.
it leans to the right of him.
Man,
that means homeboy gets around.
I guess so.
I hooked it right myself.
But let me tell you, he is a lot of fun though. It was a really fun night. But it started at around 11:30 and went till 5.
Was this before Amy Schumer? Because I remember Amy Schumer on Stern.
Yeah,
talking
I remember
about,
Amy.
Oh, he hurt me. He was so powerful. And
I don't even know who that is.
Amy Schumer, the comedian. You never heard of her?
No.
Woman chick, no. Like Amy Poehler, Tina Fey. All right, anyways.
Whatever. But anyway, really so well,
no,
Amy,
he,
listen.
He is. He likes to take control. He likes to toss you around. And I probably lost 5 hair extensions during the whole thing. Because
That's what Amy Schumer was on Howard Stern and was like, damn, dude, he's a fucking beast. But listen,
it was a lot of fun. He was very good, but it's a little crooked. It leans to the right.
Dolph leans to the right.
I lean to the right too. I hate hearing.
Oh my God!
Ain't
nobody want to hear that.
I don't
want to
live with him. I gotta
tell you, he's one of the sweetest guys I've ever met. He's extremely intelligent, and we had a lot of fun. I have nothing bad to say about him whatsoever. I've never said a bad
word
about
endorsement.
Him. I put him over every chance I get.
There you go.
Glowing endorsement.
There you go.
Nothing but positivity.
Tim, what are you doing? What are you doing next Tuesday night? Can you come back
out
here?
We gotta have more of this.
Can you come back out here next Tuesday? What are you doing? Or if not next Tuesday, huh?
Yeah, I'm around.
All right, next Tuesday, I'm going to...
I didn't
book
any Skypes that night.
All right, well,
the Skype schedule is...
I'm going
to
send you an email
we need to beef our Skype schedule up. Where
a DM. Yeah, we got to plug the Skype and the Twitter. So what's going on with Skype? What do you got?
If anybody's interested in a Skype session, just email me at sunnyskype8@gmail.com. I'll give you all the information you need, and we'll go from there. And trust me, it's a lot of fun. I have a lot of fun doing it. I really do.
Awesome, awesome.
I have to admit, I have seen a lot of really ugly, disgusting penises. But hey, you know, it's their money, it's their time, they can do what they want.
How do you deal with age? Like, what if like a fucking 13-year-old tries to see, like...
No, they have to be 18 or... If they look young, make them, like, show me proof of their age, like, up and close in the camera.
Right.
And if they can't, then I hang up.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, no doubt. All right, so hit her up. It's,
There's no messing around. I'm not going to get, like, arrested for, you know, anything with a minor. Then that's not going to happen.
No.
There was one that ended up being 16, and I immediately said, I'm sorry, I'm going to refund your money. Have a night.
Oh, yeah. The poor blue balls in that.
That's cool. That's cool, man. All right, that's cool. All right, so what's the email? One more time with the email, and then I'm gonna go on Facebook and Twitter, and I'll plug your accounts, and we'll hook it up.
Okay, the email is sunnyskype8@gmail.com.
There you go, sunnyskype8@gmail.com. Listen, I'm gonna hit you up.
Twitter,
I'm gonna and the Twitter as. Twitter.com/WWEHOFERSunny, right?
Yes.
All right, no doubt. I'm gonna hit you up after we go off the air here tonight. We'll set something up, hopefully for next Tuesday. If not, we'll figure it out.
If you want to do it.
All right, you're awesome. I love you.
You are awesome.
Love you guys.
All right, love you too. Have a good night, Tam. All right.
Bye.
All right, bye.
Oh, boom! I know I'm jerking off too tonight.
Look,
hey, that right now. I'm not even doing a Skype session. I got enough already in there.
See,
she's talking about how Dolph Ziggler used to jerk off to me when I was a kid. His shit hangs to the right. Guess what?
Me too.
It's me exactly the same thing. Me too. I used to break my dick jerking off to Sonny when I was a kid.
That's my girl, man.
It hurt.
Listen.
Yeah. What's up?
Hopefully,
goddamn, she don't hold back on the story either, does she? Jesus
Christ. Did I not tell you?
You didn't have to say a word. She was like, hey, could you shut up? I got some details here about
his
crooked ass fucking
hands. The times that I have talked to her, she doesn't hold anything back.
On the air, though?
No.
I thought, all right, yeah, maybe on the phone you guys talk like this. She just fucking...
She doesn't. She
I want to hear more stories.
Right?
I got to hear more stories.
And she's got so
what
many
am I gonna, stories. Oh, I'm in the middle of a sentence here. What am I going to not hear another story? Tuesday night. Next week, I want to sit around the campfire.
You want tanning back? There's a little sample.
I want to sit around the campfire with Miss Stitch.
There
I
want to
hear the stories.
Sample. There is a little sample. I will hit
the year up. Was 1996, children.
I will hit
I was
up.
The hottest chick on the internet.
Here's the problem.
She got stories.
Here's the problem. I will hit her up. And right now, she will say, yeah.
She's available now.
Next Tuesday night, yeah, I'll be around. I'll be available. Yeah, hit me up. But then... Next Tuesday night comes around.
You know what would help?
She's nowhere to be found.
You know what would help?
She's nowhere to be found.
If every single person listening right now would send that girl an email.
You say
hit
her
up
on Twitter. Hit her up on Twitter.
Let her know that there is a force field that she is dealing with right now of thousands of people.
The army. Go get her.
The army. Let the army do its thing and she'll know, oh, this is a kind of a, like a big... fucking bunch of people.
Y'all came in here and I was just about to end this show and I'm talking to Boone and I said, this show kind of sucks tonight, man.
I was saying it too.
It's not that good. It wasn't that good. And then, out of nowhere, we said, we're going to take one final call.
That brought us from a D- to a B-.
We're going to take one final call. And I said, caller, the final call of the night. You're on the air. And she said, I'm the final call of the night. And what did I say?
Tammy?
Tammy?
Yeah.
Is this Tammy? Sure enough, there's Tammy Sitch for you,
bro.
So
and she
that's my girl,
bro. She sounds hot.
She sounds hot.
I told you last week when we were or the
you got a crush on her from back.
Still do, bro. Yeah, I seen her at the Hall of Fame. She got in shape again. She still looked like a fucking rock star.
My girl.
It's a bad B word. I don't want to. In case she's still watching.
Yo, older fans, 30,
I'm too
40,
shot. Even look at the camera. Right now.
30, 40, 50 years old. That was Sonny. You met y'all. Remember how hot Sonny was back in the day.
He says, Boone wants 2 hours of WZR Tammy Tuesday.
He's fucking right, he does.
Tammy Tuesday. It's going to be a great day.
All right, so listen. I'm going to hit her up.
I can't guarantee you anything.
And we tried to get Waltman tonight, but Waltman must not be on Twitter. But listen, we got Tammy tonight. I'm going to hit her up. I'm going to try to have two out. There's no pay-per-views. It's just Raw.
It's UFC on Saturday.
It's UFC. I want
to rouse the
I want 2 hours of Tammy next week.
2 hours. I'll sit here 2 hours.
An hour and a half.
I can listen to that for 10 hours.
Right?
Are you kidding?
So
I thought she'd be like all politically correct. No, she. Remember when we interviewed a couple of divas, but the one diva that always sticks out in my mind, because I don't remember.
Sable.
No, we interviewed her. That was actually the first interview we ever did in our lives.
Who was the other diva?
Bobby Heenan was the second. The first diva we ever had on the show live.
Let me think.
Think Gold Dust.
Think. Oh yes. Melina.
Marlena. Terry Reynolds.
Marlena. Yeah. Yes.
She was the same way.
She was the same.
She was like, guys, why are we talking about these dumb wrestling stories? Don't you want to hear some real shit?
Some real
dirty shit.
We're
like,
what?
She's like, why don't you ask me about Goldust's penis or this? And I'm like, whoa, Jesus Christ.
Right.
Like, listen, I have never thought about Goldust's penis, but since you brought it up,
is
there a story there? Like, what's up with Mr. Gold's penis?
And by the way, Winner's Lair in the chat room, she didn't sound high. She sounded pretty fucking good.
Very good, yeah.
She sounded pretty good.
I can't tell my voice.
I sounded more drunk than her tonight, to be honest with you.
But I sound fine right now.
And she's got photos up on our Twitter where she's been training at the gym, so maybe she is in good shape. So, listen.
I hope so, because it makes the fantasy a lot better.
I want her back. I want her back next Tuesday.
Yeah.
I want her back next Tuesday.
I want her every day of my life. But yeah. What's
so we're gonna try. We're gonna try to get her back next Tuesday night for you guys if we can. I'm gonna hit her up on Twitter.
These days,
40 something.
She's well into the 40s. Think. I mean, goddamn, I was
40 something.
Teenager. She was in her late 20s.
40 something.
Ooh, she's still. Ooh, God, I still picture the old Tammy. Sunny.
You just talked to her.
Yeah, man.
For the first time.
She's not good.
First time ever.
I believe that's the first time I've
heard
her.
First time ever.
You've talked to her before.
Yeah. We're getting her back next Tuesday.
I want to jerk off.
I'm out.
We're out. Be out. Get the fuck out.
We're out.
Yeah.
Matty Boone.
What's up?
That's Tuesday night. Gave you guys a little bit of a surprise at the end. It was a surprise to Matty Boone and I as well. We're going to try to get her back next Tuesday night.
Oh, that's right.
You guys.
I didn't even think of that.
Yeah.
She was butt naked the whole time.
She was naked.
Yeah.
We should have asked her if she was still naked.
She said she was. What, you think she stopped and got dressed in between questions?
She was naked on here. And I think with the Dolph Ziggler
stuff. Listen, first of all, she was probably not naked. That's advertising.
You want to transcribe?
That's a hot chick advertising.
You want to transcribe the
Dolph
Ziggler stuff?
That's a hot chick advertising. A hot chick will say, oh, I'm naked as fuck right now. She's wearing 8 sweaters and shit. But if she can paint a picture to the jerk-offs listening, oh, my fucking tits are hanging right now. They're actually perking up still these days. I'm not that old. You know
she
what I mean?
Naked.
She wasn't naked. There's no
she
way.
She was naked. Ooh. She was naked for you guys. But listen.
Yeah, what's up?
We need to get that Dolph Ziggler. Transcribe it. We need
transcribe
that.
Transcribe what?
The Dolph
Ziggler. Her story?
Yes.
You can do that. I'd rather not post about a WWE superstar's dick.
She'd kill me if I posted.
I don't think she would. She wouldn't have said it if she didn't want it out.
I'm going to do it.
I'd ask her first. That's the polite thing to do.
I'm going
to
do it.
Miss Sitch, can I talk about your former partner's dick?
I'm going
to
do it.
I'm going to write an article about his dick.
How it hangs to the right.
Mrs. Tammy, you were speaking about a certain
dick. Does it go like up and then to the right?
Would you like to know? Because I really
don't. No, I don't.
I swear to God, I got the same problem.
We out.
It's scary looking.
We out.
It goes like this and it goes like a big fucking, like it's like a half a C. Half the letter C. Not all the way to where it's like that, but it's like that. It's atrocious, man. It's painful, too, sometimes, to be honest with you, when you're doing stuff. Feedback. Don't go right into that. Don't
feedback,
go right into that.
Man. For fuck, man. Feedback.
You asked me a question.
Don't be facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR because
I'm actually
Matt Boone WZR.
Yeah.
You're just about as honest as
careful with the slash. It's you know the slash is very similar to what we're talking about.
That way.
That's where mine goes
to the right.
Yeah.
The right.
Yeah.
facebook.com.
It comes up towards me and then to the right. So it's like a double whammy.
Oh man, what do they say that TMI?
Too much information.
Too much information.
Yeah.
Thank you for that, man.
She started it.
When my dick gets hard, it goes straight up. It don't go to the right. It don't go to the left. It goes straight up. And
I've abused mine over the years.
Anyway, we're out.
We're out.
I apologize. We're getting Tammy. Tammy.
Great show.
Tammy is coming back next Tuesday night, 8-10 Eastern time. We're gonna get her on.
But yeah,
she's coming back.
We'll see.
I'm gonna hit her up right now.
We'll see.
We're gonna do it. So we're gonna try to have her back next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern. We'll have a lot more stories tonight, like we did tonight, man. If we can get her back tonight, what you guys heard with Dolph Ziggler and Ashley Massaro, I want to get into that. And then Damian Darling, the whole arrest thing. You remember what happened with the whole arrest and everything else? Oh, God, it's crazy. We're going to try to get her back next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern time. We're out of here for tonight for Matt Boone, Ryan Clark.
That's him.
See you next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern time on...
Where?
WZRonline.com.
Thank you.